to record on here. All right, guys, let me know if you can see my screen.
We can see you.
Totally.
Okay. All right, guys, welcome to Virtual Powur Day. My name is Tommy Linick, and I'll be one of your hosts this morning. We're so happy to have everyone on here today. You're going to have a great opportunity to learn all about Powur, a company that's growing at unprecedented rates and making a major splash in the solar energy industry. And before we get started, I'd love to know a little bit more about who's with us this morning. I know that we are already dropping our names, but we have about 10 more people come in. If you could go ahead and drop your info in the chat, let us know where you're coming from and maybe how you heard about Powur, or if you're a Powur Pro, we'd love to have you in there. So welcome, everybody. Many of you guys might already know Powur, might already be in Powur, and today's really about getting some info out for the people that are looking at us for the first time. And welcome to the other five people that just joined in. Drop your info in the chat. Love to know where you're coming from. So guys, I'll tell you a little bit about myself and about Powur. So my name is Tommy Linick, and I have about half a decade of experience in the solar energy industry. I'm a tier three seller on the Powur platform, and I'm proud of it. Throughout the last 5 years, I've personally helped over 130 families to invest in solar energy, and I feel like I'm really just getting started. Because before finding Powur, I was limited to selling solar in California. In fact, when I was the sales manager at Vivint, some of you might know that name, I was confined to about a 5-mile radius where I was pretty much forced to door knock in a neighborhood that primarily spoke Spanish, and that wouldn't be a problem had I spoken more than 8 or 9 words of Spanish. So, muy poquito. Right. Some of you might know the pain of having to have someone translate for you during a presentation. I know I can't be the only one, or maybe getting a referral outside of your territory that you earned, you're not able to service, and you end up having to turn them down. It's disappointing. And I couldn't help but feel like there's a better way to bring more clean energy to more people and to be able to do it without shoveling hundreds of thousands of dollars in hopes of getting my own solar company off the ground. And that's right about the time when I heard about what Powur was doing. And I knew it was something special, something totally unique in the solar industry, something that I couldn't wait to be a part of. And I've now put up solar in multiple states. I lead a team of solar consultants spread out over 5 different states. And all of that's really possible because of Powur. So without any further ado, I'd like to talk a little bit about what Powur is all about. So we're Powur, we install a lot of solar, but we're not a solar company per se. We're a platform. And what exactly is a platform? Well, we're gonna get into that shortly, but in brief, Powur is a platform built to accelerate the adoption of clean energy. And I'd like to make a case today for why we're the right industry at the right time and why Powur is the right company to help you build a thriving solar energy business. The greatest part is this industry people are flocking to constantly. Think about what we see in the news regularly and what we feel in our wallets at home. The price of energy is going up year after year. In fact, I remember when I was paying 19 cents when I first moved out to San Diego in 2012, right? 10 years here. It was 19 cents 10 years ago. And today I paid about 45 cents, I believe. And I cannot wait to get my first house. And that's going to be possible with Powur. And I'm throwing batteries and solar all over it. All right, guys. So why is the solar industry so popular right now? It's really because everyone wants to stop wasting money on their utility bills. Where does that money go when you spend it? It's gone forever. You save up to 50% on energy costs almost instantly. You can do it with zero down financing options. You can receive a federal tax credit of up to 30% for the next 10 years. Immediately increase the value of your home by generally around 4 to 6% is what is thought to be nationwide. And it's clean. So in order to flip your switch on, you're not going to be turning on fossil fuels. You're not burning stuff in order to do so and depleting a non-renewable source. Guys, but to understand why solar is so booming right now, why it's so big, we got to understand the opportunity. So 130 million homes in the US. There's 90 million of those are eligible for solar energy, but only 3.5 million have adopted. So it's less than 4%. why do you think that could be? I mean, in 2021, someone went solar every single minute of every single day of every of the whole year. We like to think it's because of the model, right? So solar has been largely the same for many years. And while there's been a lot of innovation on technology or the systems, I mean, there's been very little innovation on the model that brings it to the customers. So our good friend Bucky Fuller is a renowned architect, some systems thinker, and considered one of the early innovators that led to solar technologies. He said it this way: to change things, don't try to fight the existing reality. Build a new new model that makes the old model obsolete. And it's true. You can't affect change by fighting the existing reality. You have to build a new model. And that's exactly what Powur did. So we've seen this in so many industries. Think about the way you do business with all the companies nowadays. Traditional retail has shifted to a world where we basically press a button and we can get anything we want. I'm pretty sure Amazon literally delivers groceries into your fridge nowadays. Like, you don't even need to leave your couch. You can have them come in your house as long as your door is open, and they will deliver groceries. It's insane. So instead of like flagging down a taxi, guess what? You got Uber on your phone or Lyft. Marriott stayed at one recently. Still prefer to go to Airbnb. It's just much easier. Blockbuster turned into Netflix, and look at Prudential, turned into EXP. And we like to think that EXP is a very good representation of something similar to our model. So guys, as far as the business model, why is it winning? So we're in a platform economy. Powur Platform connects all the players who are needed in the solar industry. And it's really simple when you think about why. I mean, installation partners, they need deals. They need contracts signed. We need, independent sellers need to have the installation partners. Homeowners need to have these vetted sources. And product partners, we all need them. So when we become a part of Powur, we really have access as an individual to leverage of the top of the top, the biggest players. And it's just a fantastic thing. So for us, we're the most important in the eyes of Powur, the independent sellers, right? We're leveraging a platform economy to provide the best possible solution there is. You get transparent cost of goods model, first of its kind. We have fully customized solutions. We leading equipment and financing partners, and buying Powur equals big value. We have an exclusive 30-year warranty in our ambassador programs, $1,000. It helps our homeowners pay their solar off quicker. And it's just an awesome concoction. So regardless of where you're coming from or what your background is, you can be successful on this platform. We have thousands of professionals succeeding on this platform. And we recently did an insight survey and learned about half of our users have previous solar experience. And about 80% of those have previous sales experience, and many have no experience at all. So if you look at some of these install numbers, I mean, look at this, 150 installs, and he's a solar sales newbie. I'm 5 years in the game and I don't have that, you know? So it's possible for everyone, regardless of where you're coming from. Powur's the ticket. So we're gonna watch a video that has three of some of our top solar energy professionals in here right now.
I just had my biggest winter in solar that I've had in 7 years. And coming from solar, having a big winter, that says a lot. My fiance quit his job last year, and now we both work from home with Powur. We're able to spend so much more time with our three children, and we're able to go on more vacations. I just bought myself a Tesla, and we also just entered escrow for a new home. I really feel like I'm living the dream life.
In just a few months working for Powur, I've discovered the real meaning of freedom, especially time freedom. I get to work my own hours, get to go to the gym whenever I want, and I get to spend time with my friends and family without having to take time off. I'm literally my own boss. On top of it, I've made more than ever before in my sales career.
Cada individuo que entra en Powur es como si fuera el propio dueño de su compañía solar. Porque Powur está enfocado en que cada uno de ustedes puedan lograr sus metas y sus sueños, pero a la misma vez que ayudamos a la adopción de la energía renovable al planeta. Me enamoré de ese trabajo porque ese trabajo me daba la libertad que no tenía en otros trabajos anteriores.
Other companies that I worked for had a terrible culture. I used to spend hours on the road driving from appointment to appointment for leads that just weren't that good. I was exhausted, I was overworked, money was tight, and I had to sell so many deals just to make a decent income. And there was time where I didn't know how I was going to pay the groceries.
Working for a boss in a big company was all I knew. At Verizon, I used to work 60 to 70 hour weeks with zero compensation for overtime. I'd wake up, go to work, come home, sleep, and start all over again. I had to request days off, and I miss a lot of Christmas dinners with my family.
Nací en Puerto Rico. En el 2009 vine a los Estados Unidos por primera vez. Mi primer trabajo fue en un hotel, haciendo housekeeping, con el que limpia los cuartos. En Texas comencé a trabajar con Target y HEB. Después conocí Coca-Cola. Cuando me hablaron de la energía solar en el 2018, busqué en Google acerca de los paneles solares. Él me introduce con Edgardo González y Edgardo me dice el plan y la estrategia que tenía para hacer crecer esto. Y yo dije, yo quiero ser parte de eso.
My friend Jonathan Brunasso, who I had worked with in several of my past solar companies, told me about Powur and how I can generate my own leads and offer customers so much more than the other companies. It just felt different, and the culture was completely different from anything that I had experienced. We just got back from Mexico, where Powur partnered with Prosperity Homes, and they took us on an all-expenses-paid trip. This is what I mean by the culture at Powur. No other company has ever done anything like that for me.
I won't lie, I was very skeptical in the beginning, having spent my whole career as a W-2 employee. Moving from guaranteed paychecks to 1099 was very, very scary for me. It was Jonathan, along with other great mentors, who convinced me that I should switch to essentially becoming an entrepreneur with Powur. When I started out in October 2021, I got help from a tier 3 sales partner to close my first few deals. Since then, I've closed 19 contracts in just a few months, and I've earned more than I ever have before.
I was blown away by how easy it is to enter a lead, and there's so much control that we have for customizing proposals for a homeowner. You can choose the type of equipment you want to offer them. You can choose the type of financing from so many options. And if you know they're getting a roof or an electrical panel, you can put that in right away. And there's so much control that we have to better serve homeowners.
You get the freedom of time and being your own boss, but you also become an expert in your field. The certification courses teach you everything you need to know. And if you ever have a question or need advice, you can dig into the knowledge base or even reach out to the thriving community of Powur sellers. I get to stick to what I do best, which is selling, and leaving the rest and brand messaging to Powur. It really is the best of both worlds.
Powur me dio la oportunidad de que sin dejar el trabajo que yo tenía, podía hacerlo part-time, y con el tiempo, ese part-time podía darme esos ingresos que yo necesitaba para comprar mi casa, siempre y cuando yo cumpliera mis metas. Esa es la libertad que te ofrece Powur. Si tú tienes la oportunidad de alcanzar cada uno de tus sueños con algo que está ayudando a miles de personas a ahorrar dinero, ¿por qué decir que no?
I couldn't have imagined that I would be living the life I am now, just 2 years into joining Powur, and I can't wait to see what we do next. My name is Cynthia Alvidrez, and I'm living a Powured life.
My name is Jeff Hugh, and I'm living a Powured life.
Mi nombre es William Contreras, y este es mi Powered life.
What do you think, guys? Pretty awesome stuff, right? Love it. All right, guys. So as a solar professional and entrepreneur, what you get on this platform is everything that you need in order to run a robust solar energy business and lucrative career. From initial lead generation to sales process to complete fulfillment of your solar projects, you get everything you need in the cloud-based platform and lets you sell anywhere you want. literally on your phone. As long as you have an internet connection, you're good. Guys, marketing assets, virtual proposal tools, online back offices, homeowner presentation materials, training, knowledge base, top of the top, affordable healthcare options that came out. If you guys don't know and you try to run your own solar energy business, you know, how much this costs? Some of the pros out there really know how many hats you have to wear and how expensive that can be. Powur, it just puts it all into one place for you. It's fantastic stuff. Here's some of the social media graphics that we have. So all of this is in your back office, powerful prospecting tools, everything that you need to send an interested homeowner, send interested, you know, potential team members, really Solar 101. And we all have vanity URLs, marketing links, all that good stuff. It's all provided for us on the Powur platform. We also have marketing essentials if you want to create your own flyers, door hangers, yard signs. I love to tattoo my homeowners' yards with yard signs every time that I go solar, and it's a fantastic prospecting tool right there. You could have all these things go by region, so you could specifically set little areas that you want. You can section your area. Let's say you're going to do an install this week. You can prepare and send out flyers for that specific area. Everything is fully customizable. Our proposal tool, really plug and play. It's just a fantastic way in order to bring homeowners solar energy and keep it simple, which is what solar energy needs to be. We want to keep everything very easy to use. User friendliness is something that in my past experience with solar was not there, right? So this is a little bit about the Powur University. There's certifications and trainings that all of us have to go through to be a tier three seller. You go through all multiple different courses, tier one, tier two. We have roofing training, all that good stuff, proposal adders, everything that you could ever want to know about solar energy or how to train a sales team or organization is right there within the Powur University. Guys, so as a SaaS platform, Powur is completely different than other solar companies, right? So the way that we get paid is Powur keeps only 15% of the net margin on any profit. And here's how you benefit from that. On proposals, you keep 70%, the lion's share of the net margin on every project. It's an average of $6,000 to $7,000 on most deals, and you get paid out daily. Right. So as soon as your job hits a commissionable stage, you're getting paid on that. We don't wait 2 weeks till the next Friday or, you know, it's immediate. I've gotten paid multiple times throughout in the middle of the night on Sundays, Saturdays. It does not matter. So we have a partner sales program. So tier three sellers. So I mentioned that earlier, and that's a earn while you learn. Way to make a commission split. So when most companies would send you out to sell on your own or give you a tiny portion, you're able to learn in the process with one of us that's able to teach you and kind of guide you along the way. We also have a lucrative revenue share program. Powur pays the 30% that they keep on every project. 15 of it goes to our bucket of team overrides. So if you choose to refer others to the platform and build a solar sales team, you can earn between $100 and $600 on every single deal that your team puts in forever for everyone. Finally, Powur is committed to the growth and creating an entrepreneurial community, and it's key. So this incredible program to become a true owner of Powur and earn stock options by hitting certain milestones, it's one of a kind. Now, when we get into this slide, I want to go ahead and introduce a special guest. His name is Bill Conley. Bill has 9 years of solar energy experience. He's a true veteran in that. He is devoted to giving back and doing good. And I'm so happy that he's co-hosting with me. Bill, if you want to hop on here, I'd love to have you on.
Yeah, thank you, Tommy. Great work. Here we are. Just totally excited to be here today. I hope all of you are starting to see, if you haven't already, just what is available to us in Powur as a SaaS platform. It's amazing that we have the ability to create and generate the tremendous amount of income that we do. But it's pretty simple here. Once you get started with Powur through your tier one certification, you're able to tag a mentor, as Tommy said, and share, earn while you learn, is probably different than most people who have ever been trainees or started a process have experienced. Usually it's you end up not making anything while somebody else makes the lion's share of money while you train. And that's not the case in Powur. From the very beginning, you're able to make money day one by splitting the revenue share, or excuse me, the revenue on a deal. So you come in as a tier one seller, as soon as you go through that tier one certification, and you're eligible to make up to 50% of the commission on a deal. And as our average commission is $7,200 on the platform nationwide, that's right there at $3,600. So from the very first deal, we're going to talk a little bit later about how quickly we can get to a proposal and a presentation and a sale. We have people that are right out of the gate making several thousand dollars in their first month at Powur. So you can earn while you learn, and then you get to tier two. So.
All right, we're on tier two, Bill.
Oh, I'm looking at two screens. That's right. We certainly are. So tier two, you get it all. Yeah. So the average commission, $7,000. Can't beat that. We can go on to our next deal, and that's the revenue share. So this is when stepping from tier two to tier three. And becoming a tier three seller, you're then able to gain in revenue share. So you're earning $7,000 on your own personal projects, $3,500 on projects that you help other people to close. And then you get to override the revenue of people that come into your business below you. So the revenue share is the third way of earning income in Powur. We have actually five separate ways to earn revenue: the personal sales, the paired sales, the override on the revenue share. And then in addition, we are eligible for stock options. Powur is a privately held company, or actually a PBC, a public benefit corporation, but we do plan in the next 36 months to go public. So at this point, when you come in, you can earn by virtue of your production shares in Powur. And so those options are right now at a fairly low rate. And can you imagine a company as successful as Powur going public and what those shares might mean to you when they do go public? My suggestion to you is work hard, get as many options available so that the time comes when we do go public, you're going to explode in your quote unquote 401k that you're building in Powur. We also provide, obviously, as you've seen a little bit, world-class training. Powur is replete with all manner of subject matter, from the Powur University to the knowledge base to daily and weekly training opportunities. You can't miss in Powur by virtue of what we have available. There is so much on a daily, weekly, and monthly basis. We have events like this one today where you come in and learn from the very beginning. You don't even have to know how to spell solar to make money here. I have to tell you that people that have no training at all have come in and, as I say, earned several thousand dollars in their very first month. So we are setting a standard. Powur started as a lead generation company behind Jonathan Budd's vision for this company to create the largest clean energy platform on planet Earth. And we started pretty modestly at zero in 2014. basically doing the front end lead generation for Solar City, which has now been folded into Tesla, which looks like it's kind of going away from solar here. Just recently, we saw reports on that.
Yeah.
So very quickly, once we got to the place where we decided to take the bull by the horns and become an actual end-to-end provider of solar as a general contractor in 2019, and then coming out with our cost of goods model for the way in which we sell solar, providing a very transparent wholesale price. Powur went from $8.8 million in 2019 to almost $100 million in 2020, to almost $200 million in 2021, to very close to $300 million this year. The last 3 years, making the Inc. 500 fastest growing companies and the fastest growing residential solar installer in the country, 3 years in a row. It is special to make it once. Powur has made it three times running. And I continue to be blown away by that, as you all should be as well. The industry. We are in the industry. I don't think it even needs to be talked about that we're in the industry that is the fastest growing industry in the world today. The whole position of our economy is geared toward renewable energy. We're right smack dab in the middle of that. Powur is the company with our decentralized technology platform to fully benefit from that. So we're in the right industry with the right product, because we have the buying power and ability to get the best products at the best prices. You don't have to shove a specific panel down somebody's throat because that's all you offer. We get the chance to select and procure the best products at the best prices, offering you, the consultant, the greatest income, again, with the company that is the best. Our ability to leverage the technology platform has put us essentially over the top. We are, I always tell people, the Uber of the solar industry. So our vision, real quick, this is our CEO, Jonathan Budd, giving you a vision of Powur. I don't know if I'm the only one, but he's my hero. So maybe some of you think the same way. So hit it.
Yeah, it's pretty powerful, no pun intended.
Jonathan Budd, I'm the CEO and founder of Powur. And if you made it this far, you've probably heard incredible reasons to join our company already. But you know, I want to take a minute to share with you where this company really came from. 12 years ago, 2010, I was making lots of money. I had a successful digital publishing company, but something was missing. And I really wanted the work that I actually do every day to be making a difference, to be helping to solve some of the challenges going on our planet. And I got a call one day from my friend Jim Bunch. And he said, "Hey man, I'm going on this trip with this organization, the Pachamama Alliance, and I think you should come. Can you come to the Amazon rainforest?" For some strange reason, I said yes. So I went down to the Amazon rainforest with the Pachamama Alliance, spending time with this culture that has no concept of trash, that has lived for thousands of years in that forest. And down there, in the middle of a ceremony with one of the elder shamans of this tribe, the vision for Powur came to me. What I knew in that moment was that I was meant to come back and start an organization, the first of its kind, that was going to figure out how to enable anyone to earn their livelihood and participate in the clean energy or solar revolution. And it took me almost 10 years to really figure out what it was, following the clues and the signs that has ultimately led to where we are today, which is this absolutely disruptive platform for the solar energy industry. Powur is truly here to make the biggest difference we possibly can, aiding our world in becoming sustainable, getting as much carbon out of the atmosphere as possible, and delivering the next generation of infrastructure that society is going to be built on. Now, on top of that, our purpose is to reward financially the people who make that happen more than they ever have been in their lives before. We have this fundamental belief that if you get paid really well to do good, then you're going to do more good. The vision for Powur is to build the largest clean energy platform on planet Earth. And I think the potential for Powur is to truly be a global distributed energy utility that is delivering essential services that we all need for survival at breakthrough costs. This is not just solar Powur. This is solar Powur plus storage so that we can become our own utility and we're truly grid independent. This is transportation, whether that's electric vehicles or other forms of transportation that are coming. This is, of course, our appliances and the electrification of the home. This is how we grow food, how we source water. All of these are going to be challenges in the future, and technologies are enabling a new type of way to meet these needs. So this is an incredibly exciting time, and the platform is just in its infancy. And we're now getting to the point where we're able to add so many different types of installers, whether it's HVAC contractors, roofers, solar installers, all of the infrastructure that we need to live in a sustainable world, save money, and lower our carbon footprint, this platform is going to be able to sell and fulfill. I truly think this represents a multi-trillion dollar industry, and there is no other company, not one, that is close to where we are today in giving you the opportunity to participate. Powur is owned truly by the people. We have now done two record-breaking crowdfunding rounds in which we let every single person in our ecosystem become equity owners of the company. In addition, we offer stock options to every single person who joins the company if they hit certain performance criteria. And we want it that way because truly our purpose here is to shift as much wealth to the people who are building the clean energy economy as we possibly can. This is truly the time to leave your mark. This is the time to go big, to make your dreams come true, to build that career, that lifestyle, that best life that you've envisioned for yourself, making a difference, doing it with people you love, and creating the financial prosperity that you know is possible for you. So it's been my honor to meet you and share with you a little about the vision, origin, and purpose of Powur. Now it's your turn to join this amazing company, and let's go out there and accelerate the adoption of sustainable energy together.
Let's go.
Right on. So yeah, it's easy to see why we love Jonathan, right? When that's who you have leading the company, you can't go wrong. It's no wonder why it continues to attract incredible people to join this company. We have some of the major players from other national companies who have flocked to Powur. The former founder of Sunrun, retired with multi-millions of dollars and was probably satisfied being on the beach in Saint-Tropez, decided to get back into into solar because of Powur, came on as an investor and a board member to Powur. We've got the former COO of SunPower as well, all manner of solar professionals on the operations side, as well as on the sales side, have come to Powur because they see we're a better way. We literally have redesigned the nature of solar and how it's provided to the consumer in a way that makes it both beneficial to them and certainly for us on the seller side, beneficial to us. So we are what's known as a certified B corporation as well as a public benefit corporation. Both of those are two distinct designations because at Powur, part of our charter is to do not only what makes money for us, but to do good, using our scale for good. So we do well by do well by doing good, or do good by doing well, whichever that way that reads. But we are giving back. In fact, our entire footprint for the solar production that we do is offset by carbon credits that we provide. And that would be from the making of the panels, not just our own footprint as a company. But that's a pretty impressive thing. We're also involved in the reforesting of the Amazon, as well as here in the United States. We're part of the Pachamama Alliance. So that's something that we can all take pride in, because it means a lot beyond just making the dollar. Obviously, we talk a lot about making income, incredible income, but the fact that we can do the right thing and give back is something that separates Powur from other companies, our corporate culture.
Yeah, and everyone, if you haven't already, grab that QR code. I like to send this to homeowners or people that are interested in Powur, because it goes through our 2021 impact. It's a fantastic tool to send off to people that want to learn about the company.
Absolutely, Tommy. So what do our customers have to say? That's probably the best reference we can get, is what customers are saying. And primarily, they're coming out with the fact that they've just been blown away by saving money. Before we knew it, the trucks were out putting solar on. On my own personal record is 16 days from the time I signed up a customer to the time we had glass on the roof, which is amazing. And that's going to happen more and more in this company. Obviously, we are dealing with construction, so sometimes things take a little longer. There are some issues, but overall, Powur is striving to become the fastest installer of solar in the best manner possible across the country. Okay, so we talked earlier about the numbers. 130 million residential single-family residences in this country. 90 million of them are eligible for solar, and yet we have fewer than 4 million solar installations. There are a couple of reasons why that is, but the bottom line is you can be part of what we're doing to level it up. How about we get to 10 million? How about we get to 20 million? How would you like to be a part of that? And you can be by virtue of signing up with Powur for a one-time $99 onboarding fee. It's not annual, it's once and once only. And then you do need to pay for our technology costs. It's $85 a month, and that's cheap at half the price. What we get for that $85, you really can put a value on it. But the massive amount of training and access and ability in Powur for our platform price, it really makes it a no-brainer.
Yeah, guys. I mean, take it this way. You can quite literally sit on an egg all year and get one single solar contract, and it's going to pay you $7,000 on average. And that's only 1/7 of what it costs you all year to be a part of Powur and to have this insane opportunity, this awesome platform that is constantly evolving, taking everything to the next level. It's truly mesmerizing. So without further ado, guys, after you get done here today, we're going to take a little bit of a 10 minute break right now, but get back with anyone and the people that referred you here, or anyone that showed you the link to get here today, and chat with them about how to get started, okay? We're gonna go ahead and take off for a little bit, and we're gonna get into a deep dive, really specific solar training. You're gonna love it, it's local specific. We have a special guest that I'm really excited to bring out, and everyone go grab some coffee and come back and let's get energized, okay?
Awesome. Okay, thanks, Tommy. We'll be right back.
you're feeling alone. Gotta think about it. Gotta dream about it. Gotta find a way to do the thing. I was living a lie, this is my confession. I was living a lie before we met. There were so many nights full of dark temptation. There were so many nights that I regret. You gave me something that I can hold on to. A little light when I'm down on my knees. I was so lost in myself when I found you. But in that moment you made me believe. You give me freedom, freedom, freedom I've been looking for. Freedom, freedom is you. You give me freedom. You give me freedom, freedom, freedom. lifted me up, lifted me up. And I was down and out. It's the highest I have ever felt. You gave me something that I can hold on to. A little light when I'm down on my knees. I was so lost in myself when I found you. But in that moment you made me believe. You give me freedom, freedom, freedom I've been looking for. Freedom, freedom is you. You give me freedom, freedom, freedom I've been looking for. Freedom, freedom is you. You give me freedom.
Back.
Welcome back, everybody. Freedom, freedom, freedom I've been looking for.
Back from break. What's going on, people? Hope you guys got some coffee. I absolutely did. Spending a little too much overtime at the Keurig machine myself. Give me 1 second. I want to get us all ready to go again. Are you seeing my screen? Can I get a thumbs up?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. All right, guys. I just want to say how happy I am again to have every single one of you here today this morning. It's really about an opportunity and how to add some rocket fuel to your ship as you embark on a journey with Powur. The company is growing at unprecedented rates and making major splashes in the solar industry. And it's because of people like you, me, and all of us here, and all of us within Powur from every different state that we're all from, that's the reason why.
10.
Sorry, before I play this, a little background. Everyone has their favorite Jonathan Budd video. And I can't get enough of this. So if you will allow me to introduce him one more time, I couldn't help but add a slide in there because I'm hosting, so why not?
10 years ago in the Amazon was born the Powur Vision, a clean energy mission that would be unstoppable like an eternal piston. It didn't matter if the haters, debaters, and dream slayers wouldn't listen because this idea cannot be put into submission. We paid the price of admission. We spit polished our model until it glistened. We rearranged atoms like nuclear fission. We made reality of our premonitions, and we estranged our competition. Then we grew exponential while these other punks just did linear addition. So here we are today, the fastest growing residential solar company in the USA. Almost 30 million. Cash in the bank, number 61 on the Inc. 5000 rank.
Just kidding. We're actually number 43. So that was last year's gala. Today, we are on the Inc. 5000 list for the third year running. Out of 32.5 million businesses, Powur is proud to be recognized as number 43 for third year running. So back to back to back to back. As today is really about training. So now this second hour, we're gonna be doing finding your why. We're gonna talk about the utility bill and local specific. We're gonna talk about something we like to call get it, submit it, tag it. And Bill Conley, our good friend, is going to be doing the 10 pennies challenge. That's going to help you guys get activated and get started right now, immediately. And we have a special social media training because I know myself and everyone else here loves to get some good stuff on that. And we have a real pro that came in and just lit it up with social. And I'm really excited to have him on. Then we'll get into what's next after that. So I'm going to pass the reins over to my friend Scott Crum. Scott is a 9-year solar veteran, again, just like Bill Conley. Big player on Powur Hitters team. I'm really excited to bring you on. Scott, you there?
Yes, I am. Thank you very much. Man, what a great job, Tommy. You guys are doing such a fantastic job. It's going to be hard to follow you guys, but I'm going to do my best. Like Tommy said, I have been doing this for 9 years, and I've been in sales my whole life. I've been with Powur, it'll be 1 year in just a couple of weeks, which blows my mind how time flies. But what the slide says here right in front of you folks, clarity equals power, is so accurate. If you don't know why you're doing something, how can you possibly do it well? I often tell people, if you ever play darts, I love to play darts, put a blindfold on, throw a dart at the dartboard and see if it hits a bullseye or not. You might not even hit the bulls or the whole target. You might hit the wall. You might hit a plane of glass and shadow that glass. You have to be able to see what you're going for. You have to have a target. 30 years ago, I learned a lot about sales I didn't know right now. And I had a saying I've used over and over and over for 30 years. You probably have all heard it. I'm still going to repeat it. The only difference between you now and you in 5 years are two things. The people you meet and the books you read. I've been saying that for 30 years, but it's not accurate anymore. I still say it, but it's not the truth. Well, it's the truth, but it's altered. We live in a different world. Everything's faster. Everything's quicker. When I first started doing sales, 35, 40 years ago, more than that, actually, we didn't have the internet. We didn't have smartphones. It literally was books. Or if you were lucky, those little cassette tapes, you had your pencil there so you can adjust it whenever it got, no, I got to fix my tape. I can't hear. I got to get my motivation in the morning. Now we have all this stuff at our fingertips. So I've changed this a little bit. I think that where you are today and where you're going to be, not in 5 years, not in 3 years, but 1 year or 1 month or 1 week really is at our fingertips with action. And it's not just the books you read, but we have all these amazing technology. You want to learn about selling solar? We got 1,000 videos on, hundreds of videos at least. You want to learn about speaking better or losing weight or learning to climb a mountain? It's all at our fingertips. People, it's easy to meet people now. I have thousands of people that follow me on Facebook. Are they really my friends, my associates? It's not meeting people, but it's actually associating. It's actually being with people, learning from them, spending time with them. So we have all this at our fingertips. We just have to choose to use it. So my question to you, and Tommy, I guess I'm going to let you go ahead and do the slides there. If you can go to the next slide there. My question to you is, what's your why? What's your plan? Powur has a great tools. We have more tools. It blows my mind. 8 previous years of doing solar cells, I've done more in 12 months than I did in 8 years in many, many ways. Maybe not numbers. I've done 1,500 homes in solar in my life. But how I do it, how smart I do it, how better I do it, Powur has taught me to do it fine-tuned, perfect. Maybe not perfect, but as close as I can get. Here's one of our plans. Here's one of our helpful tools. You have some barcodes there on your screen. You can actually pull your phone up there and put it on there, and you can just download this business plan. Or if you're in the platform, you can download it. We have all this technology at our fingertips with our knowledge base and our Powur University for you to use. We're just going to go through just a teeny bit of this part, but you need to have a plan. You need to have a why. Tommy, if you go to the next screen, please. My why is different than your why, right? Where do I want to be in a year? Why I want to be there? Why I'm doing what I'm doing? You need to start thinking about that. In every part of your life, in my opinion, You know, I love helping people learn. I help people getting better. You need to decide why you are going to do solar, if you're going to do solar, why you're going to lose weight, why you're going to learn to speak Spanish, right? What's your why? And then you're going to start breaking that down into bite-sized bits. If you want to try to lose 50 pounds and you don't eat for one day, you're not going to lose 50 pounds. You know, if you want to learn to sell solar and you watch one video or go to one seminar and never talk to another person, you're not going to learn to sell solar. So then you take those and break them down into small bites. What are you going to do every single day of your life? How are you going to start? And you got to actually write a plan. I know, Tommy, I believe you have somebody that has a why that is, that's maybe even a very, very important to them. Would they like to share for a moment?
Yeah, definitely. So before I introduce this individual, I just wanted to mention your why is, it's really got to be something that just drives you so much that it's like you want it as much as you want to breathe, right? Like you need this to get you up in the morning when you could just sleep in. You need it to get you to do your work during the day when you could easily hit up your friends or go out to lunch or take some time off. Your why has to be something that it has to be that strong. And I'm super happy to bring on my good friend, Kenny Kramer. He has a why that it really, truly has meaning. And it's something that makes him strive for success every single day long. So Kenny, if you're there, I'd love to bring you on for a second and just talk about your why. So we have Kenny, I think you're on mute, brother. Kenny, we have you on mute, man. Can you hear me? There we go. No, are we gonna okay, get well. This, Kenny? Oh, sorry, man. Oh, I wish we.
You know what? That's okay. Maybe we can bring him on a little bit later if he
can. Yeah, hopefully Kenny can work it out.
Sorry, Kenny. It's funny. You know,
can you hear me?
Oh, yeah. Oh.
All right. You
there you are. Barely.
All right. Sorry about that. Hey, everybody. Just to talk about my why, I guess you could say. It's my son. I know a lot of people may have kids. A lot of people may not. I'm not really sure, but, and it's probably typical. Everybody says their kids, their why. But, just before my son was 3 years old, he was diagnosed with, acute myeloid leukemia. And I'm not sure if you guys know what that is. Maybe you do by now, but it's cancer of the blood. And, he pretty much just before he started treatment, lost his life for about 3.5 minutes. Right in front of our face. And between me and my wife at the time, wasn't necessarily sure how to respond to that. And he went through about 6 or 7 months of hard chemotherapy, almost lost his life again from all the chemicals and the drugs they put in the system, and just pretty much not even recognizing my own kid. So now, about 6 years later, I'm at his football game. So... I'm glad to have a piece of him with me every day. That's why I wake up. That's why I hustle. That's why I'm inspired. That's what drives me. Like, he's my only son. So, you know, when you have that to look forward to every day, the other things just seem so much easier. Talking to people, getting to know people. Some people may have anxiety talking to people or whatnot, and getting to learn about our opportunity here. I wouldn't even be able to be here, honestly, if it wasn't for what we're doing with Powur and the platform. My son's happy about it. Everybody's happy about it. So if you have anything that you have that's that important to you, just when you wake up, think about that every day. Just, I'm blessed. So I appreciate the opportunity to talk to you guys. It's very important. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for that. I think I can speak for the rest of the room. That's a why that you wake up and you need that, like you need air. Like, you know, you can always fall back on that. And, Scott, I'll go ahead and let you take it from there. Thanks, Kenny.
No, thank you, Kenny. We all have our whys, and you know that is gigantic, right? That's a huge why. My why is different than his why, right? We're all different. I just turned 59 years old. You know, older than most of you, younger than some of you. My why is more about freedom. You know, every day I get up and I work as much as I want and I play as much as I want. And I'm setting up a fantastic inheritance for my two boys who I love as much as Kane loves his. You know, mine are 30 and 26. And you know what? My why is building for my enjoyment now and their future. That's my why. I love teaching people how to be successful. I've been a coach my whole life, and that's my passion. You got to figure out yours. This little chart you see in front of you, I'm going to go over just a second here. This is just the beginning. This is just the tip of the iceberg. But you need to start thinking like this in life. I promise you it'll make things better for you. You know, we're going to have a 3-minute break here in a second. And if you have a piece of paper, if you weren't able to download this, I want you just to start writing some of your whys down. In this list here, they say, you know, try to find the first 10. If you can't find 10, I don't care. What's the most important one? I mean, we know it is what it is for Kenny, right? What is your most important one? And then what's the second one? What's the third one? Maybe start breaking some of those down. Happiness. Does it mean more free time like I have? Because we have this program, this platform in 27 states and growing, I literally travel all the time. You know, I work because my computer was wherever I'm at. I'll be in South Carolina here in a few days for the third time this year. I'm in Vegas all the time. I'm in Texas. I travel and play all the time. And where my computer is, I work. That's part of my happiness, right? There's people on our platform that live in Mexico and work from the ocean every day. Health-wise, what's your health? What's your wealth? What do you want? So, you know, Tommy, we're going to go ahead and start that 3-minute thing, but please, folks, take this serious. Start thinking about what your whys are. And we're going to give you guys 3 minutes to write this stuff down.
Think about things that drove you to invest in your business. Like what kind of freedom you're looking for. What are you tired of in your life? What challenges do you want to overcome? What legacy do you want to leave behind? Do you want to make a lot of money? More than before? How much exactly?
And I know people are writing while we're talking. I hope we aren't distracting, but I'm gonna continue with that as we're doing this. If you want to make $100,000 a year, break that down by the month. You know, break that down by the week. If you want to lose 50 pounds, same thing. Start breaking those down into bite-sized bites eventually. Right now, we're just asking. Like that's a good pun.
That was a good one.
My goal is to make this 12 inches long. You know, I'm 3 inches into it now. Right now we're looking at the overall picture. This is the place to start, but it really is just a start. You got to start breaking it down. And this software, this platform, this business plan is going to help you be successful if you use it. What I was talking about with the books that you read and the people you actually associate with earlier is only as good as using them. I know a lot of people that have bought 40 books, but they just sit on their shelf. They don't read them. You know, they don't go to any organization meetings. They don't meet new people. They don't go to Chamber of Commerce. They don't go to become somebody who gives back in the society, joins different clubs, and not for their own gain, but actually to give back and learn and help. So I know for me personally, this last year has been a whirlwind of amazement. You know, I can write my own ticket anywhere I want selling solar. I have 8 years of experience before this business. Anybody will take me in a second. There's not one place I would rather be than Powur. It has changed my life. It has been fantastic. My freedom, my happiness, my ability to help other people is at an all-time high. And everybody knows that I'm Spectacular Scott because every day I'm always spectacular, but it's even that much easier having powerful Powur on my team. Well, thank you. I hope you guys actually really did take the time to write some of these ideas down. And if for some reason you weren't able to, I hope you at least thought about them. I hope you actually have some whys, some beliefs. And then I hope that you actually take the next step and start figuring out how to break those down into smaller pieces to help, you know, what the next step's going to be. How do I take this amazing platform, this amazing opportunity, and how do I make it work for me? And the best part about that is there are dozens upon dozens upon dozens of people who will hold your hand and help you along the way. They are going to be your mentor. They're going to be your teammate, and they are going to help you be successful. All you have to do is put in some effort. One of my other favorite sayings is action never equals negative. Now, what I mean by that is I might go do something five times and then I get zero results of it. But somewhere else where I never expected, I get another result I didn't expect. I promise you that action always brings some form of positive back to you. But you have to put the action in. Nobody's going to do it for you. We will hold your hand. We will help. We will mentor. We will teach. But you have to put the action in. And I believe that Tommy is going to introduce the next person that's going to help you make those actions come true. Tommy?
Yeah, so guys, does anyone, before I go into anything else, did anyone have an aha moment or something that they want to share about their why or something that hit home? Feel free to jump off mute and give us your thoughts. I know sometimes the why is kind of personal, but is there anyone out there that wants to step up?
Hey, if I can just cut in here, Tommy, real quick, I was, and I'm not so absolutely sure if it's entirely in keeping with the why, but I wanted to introduce very briefly and highlight Tony Brennan, who's been on this platform for a very short time, right around 60 days right now, but has just come out like a house of fire in 30 days from a position of not having had any solar experience previously, and really little to no sales experience. But I'd like Tony to share a little bit about what's happened for him in these past 2 months, and maybe the why will come out in that. If you're there, Tony, can you come off of mute and share with us a little bit? If, let me see here, I might have caught him off guard, and he might not be, I'm not seeing.
We have a Tony. Yeah. Five.
Anthony Brennan.
Three.
Okay. Three. If he comes back on later.
He's at a restaurant, apparently.
My bad.
Probably selling some deals, Bill. That's probably,
yeah, you know what? He's gone so fast, I can't keep track of him now. So
he might even own that restaurant.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Okay. Well, another time, Anthony, I tried.
Do I have my friend Frankie Favolaro on here? By chance?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Frankie, I love it. So guys, if you have trouble like thinking that you have enough time to do these kind of things, we mentioned that Powur is a platform that allows you to plug in and do things on your own time. Now, Frankie is a friend of mine for the past 20 years. He has been just constantly grinding. He has two jobs. He has a toddler, the cutest baby in the world, so pretty. And he still finds a way to come out and get utility bills, schedule presentations, work around my calendar. The guy is fantastic. And Frankie, if you want to just say a couple words, just for those that think they might not have enough time, just to give them some encouragement.
Yeah, so as far as time, like, I have very limited time every day as it is. Like you said, two jobs, a one-year-old baby girl at home. So I got a lot going on. Hard to find all the extra time or wanted time that I want to put into the business. But I mean, just being able to have this opportunity and ability to work when I need to and when I can has been awesome. Not where I want to be yet, but shoot, I mean, with the opportunity that I have, it's inevitable that it's going to come soon. So
love it. And yeah, Frankie, thank you so much, Frankie. Appreciate you hopping on. Frankie has no solar experience. He's going to be earning while he learns, you know, and it's a process and it takes a little bit of time. And, you know, I've been in solar 5 years and I feel like Scott's been in her nine, Barry's been in her nine, Marisa that's with us has two. And guys, I still feel like some days that I don't know what I'm doing, you know? So like, it's a constant evolution and we appreciate you jumping on, Frankie. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Thank you.
All right, guys. So on to the next portion of the agenda. We did find your why. We talked about a couple different whys, talked about some time, location, freedom things. Guys, we're going to get into a special portion of the utility bill training. And we have a fantastic person for this. Marisa, if you are on, she has 2 years of solar energy experience. She's crushing it. 20 years of real estate experience. Go ahead and take the reins, Marisa.
Thank you so much for that intro. And hello, everybody. Thank you for being on the call. I'm very happy to be sharing this section with you. Just like it was mentioned a moment ago, I have 20 years real estate experience, but only 2 years solar experience. And in those 2 years of solar experience, I was able to get to a T3 mentor in my area. I've mentored a lot of deals. I've helped a lot of homeowners. And so I wanted to be able to share with you guys that although you may not come from a solar background, you can still do this business. And it's going to start with this training that I'm going to give right now of understanding the utility bill. Okay, so I'm going to go through how to understand that bill, why it's important, why having a clear copy is important, and we'll go from there. Okay, so, but basically, I want you guys to all understand that electric bills are complicated and they're different for every utility. What's worse is that they're always being changed, they're being manipulated, the rates are getting higher, there's all these different rate schedules that come out, and just all these different schemes by the utility companies in order to, one, confuse the client, and two, to charge the client more for the same product that they get, that they've been using. So it's important to understand that most Americans don't understand the costs and fees on their utility bills. I didn't know what mine was prior to getting into solar. So it's important that us as sellers, that we understand those bills and that it's crucial that we show those to the client so that they understand why it's important to convert over to solar. Because we know that when they convert to solar, in most cases, there's tremendous economic and environmental benefits. We just got to show that to the client. Okay. All right. So reading the electric bill is going to give us insight and what we need to fully understand our clients' energy habits. Guys, it's not just the dollar amount that they're paying monthly, which as we, some of us know, can vary based on household. You can have the same houses, same size homes next door, and they have a total different energy usage, right? So it's not just based on the amount they pay, it's also based on the amount of energy that their household consumes. According to a study by the U.S. U.S. Energy Administration in 2019, the average annual electricity consumption in the United States per household is about 10,399 kilowatt hours. So that breaks down to just about 867 kilowatt hours a month that the average American is using in their home, right? And of course, depending on the utility where they're getting that energy from, the details and the rates are going to vary, obviously. It's also important to know that there are several charges that are often listed on the electric bill. They get charged for delivery. They get charged for transmission. It's not just for the energy that they're using. They're also getting charged to generate that electricity, right? So when we look at that bill, we're looking at delivery, transmission, distribution charges, grid maintenance charges, wages for worker salaries, service fees. Some bills have franchise fees, wildfire recovery charges. There is a slew and plethora of charges that are getting charged to our homeowners on their bills. And even most solar professionals don't quite understand what all these bills, what all these charges are, okay? So that's important to know. That's why we want to get a clean, clear copy of the bill and take a detailed look at it. Your customer is going to receive a utility bill each month. And where those calculations are going to come from on their bill is from this electric meter here. So the connection between the customer and the utility is the electric meter. This is what the utility uses to calculate how much to charge the customer each month. The electric meter is going to record what the homeowners are using in that home, and it's going to be calculated in what's called a kilowatt hour, KWH, as that unit of electricity. So what makes that electric meter turn? Well, almost half of the electricity that we use in our home today is coming from our heating and cooling. More than any other major appliance, HVAC systems make up about 46% of the average US home's energy consumption. Then after that, we've got water heaters, we've got our other major appliances, we've got lighting, and then any other device that we plug in each day is what's using up that utility or using up that energy in that order. So what does this mean? Well, anytime we use a kilowatt hour of electricity, the electric meter spins and the utility knows they can charge us for the unit of electricity on our next bill. So it's how they determine what they're going to be charging us. So just based on that information that I've shared already, I got a quick question for the audience. Do you, the audience, have any idea why it is so important to learn how to read an electric bill? Give you a second or two to think about that. But the main reasons it's important for us to learn how to read an electric bill, number one is that we're gonna need to learn that to determine the proper size of the solar system that our customer is gonna need. We also need to educate the customer about their energy costs so they know what they're paying for energy today. Once we do that, it's easier for us to be able to calculate the savings that they're gonna get once they switch over to solar. We also want to know the quality of the customer's cost of power. Like, what are they getting in that power cost? What is that exact amount? And then we want to make sure that we can qualify the customer for financing and the different options that we have. That electricity bill, a clean and clear copy, is going to be able to help us do that, help us do a good job doing that. All right. It's very important for us to understand as we're helping a homeowner that solar is going to be the second or the third most important decision and most expensive decision a homeowner is going to make in their lifetime. So understanding their utility bill is going to be imperative to properly educate them and to even determine if they're eligible for solar and what savings can come from going solar. So super important to understand that. You know, the value of solar is all going to come down to the value proposition that we can present to the homeowner. And each homeowner is different. Each family is different. They're going to have a different need when it comes to their energy costs. So when it comes to their value proposition, a couple of things we want to know is how much are they currently paying for power right now? You know, how high are their electric bills? Here in California, the higher the bill, the more savings we can get them up front. Lots of times it's as much as 50%, depending on what they're paying. But defining your customer's value proposition is going to be based on real accurate data from the utility. It's not guesswork. Okay, so that's another reason we need a clear, clean copy of the bill. Okay, the value proposition is going to be based on the customer's kilowatt hour consumption, right? So that's the first thing they're going to be looking at is what's their kilowatt hour consumption. Also, what is the cost that they're currently paying per kilowatt? Here in California, on average, I'm seeing 38, 39, 41 cents a kilowatt is what they're paying to the energy company. We need to know what that number is. It's also going to show them what the solar kilowatt production can bring them. If they're currently paying 41, for example, and we can design a system that's bringing it to them at 16 cents, you see how we can show them that value proposition? Also, the financing parameters is a part of that value proposition. How much is the down payment, if any? What type of loan product are we going to match them up with? Okay, so again, each household could be a totally different value proposition. It's going to all be based on what their needs are and where we can find them that value. There's another couple of parameters that we use on a regular basis that shows value proposition. For example, battery storage. In some markets, battery storage is a great value proposition. It's very valuable to the consumer. Other markets, roofing, HVAC. We can add energy efficiency adders to the system. Those are value propositions and value adds that might help make that client make the solar decision easier. And then also in many markets, there's additional incentives and rebates that are available that help with that homeowner value proposition. So, question for you guys, any key takeaways? What is your key takeaway for why the electric bill is so important? And I'll give you just a second to think about that.
Yeah, you know, Marisa, I can hop in. If you don't have an electric bill, you can't accurately help a homeowner without just really throwing spaghetti noodle at a wall. You know, you have to have that information. You can't be cut off. No half bills, no missing info, no just photo of the usage. It doesn't help you. And generally, if that happens, it's because they're not confident in you or you haven't gained enough trust.
I would agree with that. The more and more you practice asking for a clean, clear copy of the electric bill and you explain to them why we need that, the easier it's going to be to gather that. But let me give you guys a good example of what a clean, clear copy of an electric bill looks like. So it's not just an electric bill. I'm going to emphasize clean, clear, current copy of an electric bill. That is the best way we can help a homeowner. If we're looking at their history from 6, 7, 8 months ago, things change in that amount of time. Maybe they're on a different program. Maybe they're on a different rate. If we're presenting to them based off of that, we're not going to be able to show them a true value add and a true value proposition that's going to help them make the transition to solar. Okay, so this is what an example of what a clean, clear electric bill looks like. It's going to contain the customer's name and the account information. It's got to be clear and legible so we can see it. It's also going to include a graph that shows their consumption information. Many bills gives you the last 12-month consumption information right on the bill. Some don't, but many do, which is another reason we need a clean, clear copy of all pages of the bill. And it's also going to provide the cost for the month so that we can properly calculate the savings that this client is going to get once they do make that transition over to solar. Okay, so if we have all of those pages, we can make the best presentation for the client. There's been many cases where as a mentor, the mentee would send me maybe just the front page. And they say, well, it shows the kilowatt hours, it shows their names, and it shows how much they paid. You know, why doesn't that work? Well, we're still missing a lot of information, even though we have those three factors. There's other things we need to know. What about the last 12 months? Are they getting any discounts? We need to see those things, and none of that's going to be reflected on just the first page of the bill. Okay, so audience, and you already have the answer, but is this a good example of a clear, clean, and current utility bill? Anybody want to shake their head or nod their head? I see thumbs down. I see shaking our head. This is not a good example. This is only a partial image of the bill. It does not include a usage graph, nor does it include the annual information. So it's only providing us limited information, and we're not able to make a good detailed proposal and presentation for the homeowner off of this. Okay, so we would reject this and say, can you please get a clean, clear copy? What about this one? I've seen this one a time or two. Clean, clear copy? Unfortunately, no. This is the utility rate schedule for the utility. This is not personalized. It does not include the customer's information or the usage data. So we would not be able to accurately help a homeowner if this was presented as their electricity bill. Okay. So I think I'm presenting the case of why we really, really need a good, clean, clear copy of a bill. But there are a few other key takeaways that, since we have a few moments, I will share those with you. So when it comes to a bill, many utilities combine their bills. So on some of those bills, you're going to see electricity, but you also see gas and water on the same bill. That's totally okay. We still need a clear copy of all pages of the bill. We will just take out what we need for the electricity portion and be making our numbers based off of that portion. And then also on those electricity bills, you're looking for mainly two main categories, the supply category and the distribution transmission category. That's another reason we want a clean, clear copy of the bill. We want to be able to pull that bill up and show to the homeowner all these different line item charges that are coming up on their bill so we can show them what their avoided costs are going to be by going solar. Okay, so you've got those two main categories that you look for on bills, and many bills are including other line items like gas or water. Okay, so the example in front of you. This is an example of a bill from one of the cities, one of the municipalities, and we've taken a section out of the bill. A good reason for a clean, clear copy of the bill is because you can see on this bill all of these line item charges that are here that make up the total cost to the homeowner. Okay. One of the line item charges that I want to point out is this one called a customer charge. Customer charge. So this bill reflects a flat customer charge from the utility every month. In general, that's called a utility service charge. We'll see it called a customer charge on the bill. And this is an unavoidable charge for being connected to the grid. Okay. So at any time that we're helping a client make the transition to solar, even if they're getting 100% of their energy from their system, they're still going to have to pay a grid connection fee. They're still going to be connected to the grid. So they're never 100% independent in that regard. Okay, so that's called our customer charge. You want to make sure you look out for that so you can advise clients of that. Also, on this bill, we're going to do an example where we're going to show you how to calculate what the customer is currently paying to the energy company for their energy costs. Okay, and so the way that we would do that, once we have a clear, clean copy of the bill, we can see all the line items. We want to take the amount of $81.18, which was the total cost of their energy. And then you want to divide that by the 311 kilowatt hours of consumption that they had that month through the grid. Once you do that math, you're going to come up with an amount of 26 cents per kilowatt. 26 cents per kilowatt. So that's how we figure out exactly what the homeowner is paying today from the grid. And then that's the number that we can use when we're showing them the value of switching over to solar, okay? Now, I do wanna add a caveat. Another reason you need a clean, clear copy of the bill is because there are many times when there are other charges that are gonna be included in that total cost of electricity. Charges such as an adjustment charge, a late payment might be included in there. Also, a credit could be included in there. In California, we have credit programs where they provide credits. It's not a permanent program, but they could have a credit on that bill. So you want to look through that bill and make sure that there are no other adjustments that are coming out or being added into that electricity cost. If there are, make that adjustment so that you get the accurate price per kilowatt hour. I hope I am making sense on that. But again, that's why we need a full, clean, clear copy of the bill so we can have an accurate determination. All of these numbers, this information is not going to be reflected on page one. Okay. Now that we've broken down the bill, we've talked about a clean, clear copy. What's the best way for your customer or for you to help your customer get you a clean, clear copy of the bill? There are some common practices that can make that task a little bit easier. One of the easiest ways that I found is while I have the customer there on the call, on the Zoom, or I'm standing in front of them with my phone in my hand, we can go right to the utility and log in and download a PDF version of their last statement, their last billing statement. So you just log into the utility with the client, put in their username account information, go to the billing section, go to the statement section, and download a clean, clear copy of that bill and either email it or text it to yourself. Okay, so that's a way that we can get that. Another way would be to scan a copy of their most recent bill. Maybe they have the hard copy in their hand and they're standing in front of you with it, with all five or six pages, okay? You wanna scan that copy, make sure it's a recent copy. You wanna scan it, but make sure that scan is clear and legible. If you go to the camera or the notes section on your phone, there's usually a scan to PDF. And it's usually the easiest, most cleanest way to get a copy of that bill. Another way to do it, probably the third way, maybe a little bit less desirable, is to take a picture with your phone, right? The reason why that's a little less desirable is because if it's not a high resolution photo, the image comes over blurry sometimes. So you wanna make sure that you're using a high resolution a photo or image with that picture, and that it comes over clear, so that when we send it back to the contract team, they got a clear copy of everything they need on that bill. Okay, so those are the three easiest ways to get the bill: log in and get it, use your phone, get a copy from the client right there. Just please make sure you get all pages and that it's a clear copy. And then lastly, I want to share with you guys what it looks like post-solar. So here's a few examples of what a bill looks like after your client goes solar. A few slides ago, I mentioned to you about the customer charge. Here's an example of a solar bill, and they only had an $8.23 customer charge. That's that grid connection fee that they're going to get each month, right? And it's going to vary. Some months a little bit higher, some months a little bit less. This month, $8.23. Here's an example of Edison, where it's showing a negative electric bill credit for the client. They've generated excess energy and it's at the grid. It's sold to the grid. So there's a credit there for them of $262. Another example down here, pre-solar, this bill was $450, give or take. Post-solar, this bill was $125, give or take. And then here's another example on the Edison bill. This is pre-solar. They're pulling all their energy from the grid. And then post-solar, they're only pulling a tiny bit from the grid. This month, they didn't pull from the grid at all. So it's always a great idea to ask your customers for an electric bill so you can share success stories with your new prospective clients, show them what their bill is going to look like once they go solar, the savings that they're going to get and receive from going solar and making that change. Really exciting to look at those things. And with that, I'm going to ask once again, if there are any key takeaways. At this point, if anybody wants to unmute, we've got a little bit of time extra. I went through that a little quickly. If anybody wants to unmute and just share what they learned about the utility bill or understood why it's so important to get a clean, clear copy of the bill. Anybody want to share?
Well, this is Greg Hart and Marissa, and excellent training. All you guys have been fantastic today. I just want to start with that. And the thing that I found very important with what you said and what resonates with me is you're there to help the customer first and foremost, and they can find any type of information on Google, but you're there to curate that information. So the customer's not going to care what you know until they know that you care. And if you take the time to see the intricacies of their bill, you can show them what the real value proposition is. Because if you're going to go and give them an recommendation, it's best that you know what you're talking about when you recommend, or you're just trying to be a cashier. Therefore, you should have the diagnosis of their problem, and then you prescribe the solution. And that's kind of why it's really important. That's my takeaway, is why it's important to do that. Because if you give a prescription without a proper diagnosis, then that's malpractice. And we just want to make sure we do the job the best possible, and that puts you in the best position to help your customer and be compensated greatly in the process.
I love that. Thank you, Gregory, for that example. It was a great example. I've heard it before, but it's just like going to the doctor. Like Gregory said, you need the right diagnosis. You need the right prescription. Because if you don't go there and get diagnosed, it's malpractice. If you don't have the bill, we're gonna be doing malpractice on this solar system. I love that. Is there anyone else that may want to jump off and share for the next minute?
I'll say something really quick. There's a particular utility company, Anaheim Public Utilities, which is different than Southern California Edison as far as what you're going to need from the customer, because they don't have a graph, so it doesn't show a year's worth of usage on one bill. So with Anaheim Public Utilities, you either need the last 12 bills or you need the latest bill. And then they have a sheet that you can download from the Anaheim Public Utilities that will give you the kilowatt hour usage for the other remaining 11. But just getting one bill, you're going to be surprised. If you haven't used it before, it does you really no good. That's the one thing. And another thing that I just wanted to ask you specifically, Marissa, is if you have a brand new homeowner and they just moved in and they have no current usage for that particular house, what do you do to get them solar?
So very, very good points, Barry. What he's pointing out is that some utilities, you're actually going to have to take another step, go one step further, maybe jump on a phone call or go to the website and export the last 11, 12 month worth of kilowatt hour usage. So yes, in some cases we have to do that. And then in those cases where we don't have a bill, it's a brand new homeowner. There's a couple of ways. There's a very good training that we have at Powur that teaches you how to figure out what the usage is going to be based on the size of the home, the family members in the home, and the appliances that they're running. Or you can just run a load calculator, low consumption calculator, and figure out what it is specifically for that home and design to that way. But until you get to that point, I'd always recommend partnering with a T3 or a tier 3 seller so they can walk you through that on your very first one so that you really know what you're doing to make sure you're giving that consumer a good solar experience.
Marisa, can I touch on Anaheim just real quick?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Something I learned with Paul Leon, and I learned it the hard way, with Anaheim Public Utilities, they're pretty much saying it's not even worth for the homeowners to go solar. You could try, but their buybacks are terrible. So extra energy that the client is producing during the day, they're buying it back about 5 to 6 cents per kilowatt hour. At nighttime, they're buying it back at 19 cents. So you're gonna have to size the system bigger than 120, 130% offset. So I had to learn on a project the hard way. So just do your research on Anaheim Public Utilities. When I heard of that utility, I ran over here because I need to touch on this.
Hey, and Anthony, just to piggyback on that, because I did the same thing looking at them. They are not an annual NEM aggregator. So it's monthly. So there are a lot of little utilities, just for those of you in California, the municipal utilities that all have their own solar programs. This is what we're looking at and hoping that we don't run into in the whole NEM 3.0 argument that's gonna be coming up. We won't talk about that today, but, and that's why we focus on the big three, is that the greatest opportunity for savings and the way that this works best is to focus on PG&E, SDG&E, and SCE. Anaheim is an example of one that it's almost better to size a system smaller than the 100% so that you can have them making power when they're using it and actually using the power that they make. But that's for another talk, another time. Marisa, you did a phenomenal job in describing the bill process and how it works. So thank you so much for that.
Thank you, Bill.
That was actually fantastic. If I can, I'm going to jump in on top of Bill there for 1 second. That was Marisa, such a great job. The nice thing about this is we're just talking about California. We're in 27 states. We're dealing with dozens upon dozens upon dozens of different utility companies, but we have all the experts at our fingertips. If you don't know, there's a mentor here who will help you, who's done it before, who's already made those learning curves and those mistakes. So this whole platform is not to teach you how to solve every problem today, but to let you know that we have your back. We're going to hold your hand. We're going to teach you. We're going to help you be successful. That was such a great job. Thank you so much.
I have a question, Marisa. Can you hear me? Hello?
Yeah, Frank, we can hear you.
Oh, yes. Marisa, I want to ask you, could you go through what I learned today is that I've been using just my camera on my phone to take a picture of a bill, but your second step was really good and I haven't thought about that before. Could you repeat that one more time?
Yeah, so a little hack. If you have an iPhone, it may work on Android as well. You know how you have a notes? You have notes in your phone? If you go to notes and you push the little camera, there's a scan option and it will scan it like a PDF. You just take a picture of the document and it captures it and it scans it like a PDF. So it's not a JPEG, it's not a photo, and it doesn't come over blurry. It's nice and clean.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
And I see like in the chat, Gary Bird asked a question. What are the main utilities they suggest you focus on in California? I guess what I would say is if you're new, the main three are PG&E, SCE, and SDG&E, and you can kind of learn more with your tier threes as you go on with the more specific little ones. Like you have some way out there, like Pacific Powur above PG&E, where you're at the top, and all these little municipal. There's a bunch of utilities, and all of them have different ways of going about solar. So it's a great chance to learn and not go in there with really nothing to work with. Does that answer your question, Gary? I'm gonna assume that's a yes. Awesome, got the yes in the chat. Okay, cool. Scott, did you want me to go ahead and share the screen again and roll through your slides for the next one up, or did you want to share your screen?
No, go ahead. Actually, I got this brand new computer. I don't have everything set up correctly yet here.
That's darn, gosh darn computers. Give me 1 second. Seeing my screen, everyone?
We are.
Yes. Cool. Marissa, that was fire. I like knew immediately that was going to be all you. And I mean, you did a great job. Thank you so much for that. Appreciate it. Guys, so we got through Find Your Why. We did a utility bill training right now. And next up, we're going to talk about that term that we like to say is get it, submit it, tag it. And none other than our 9-year veteran, Scott Crum, to come up here and crush this one for us. Thank you, Scott.
No problem. Thank you. This might be my favorite part of the business. I love the challenge of talking to people and getting bills, getting possibilities to help people save money. And so for me, I'm going to start with what I do. I talk to everybody I know. If you are in a elevator with me or in the line at the bank or sitting next to me at a countertop at my favorite pub having a hamburger, you are going to hear the word solar out of my mouth. I promise you. And the way I do it is I ask questions. My favorite question to ask in the whole world is, so what do you do? And then I shut up. And people, are kind. Here's this old grudging man next to me asking me what I do. I better answer him, and they'll tell me, oh, I'm a school teacher or I'm this or I'm that. And they answer the question. And because people are kind, 9 times out of 10, they ask me what I do when they finish. Door open. And I say the same thing every single time. I say, you know what? I just help people save money by going solar. That's all I say. And I shut up again. Well, I never shut up. That's not true. But I don't talk about solar. I don't go past that unless they say something. Oh, you know, we got solar last month. We love it. Or, oh, I wish I owned a home. You know, or I've been thinking about solar. Or my dad sells solar. It doesn't matter. Whatever they say, I have an answer. I promise you. We got solar last month. One of my favorite answers. Fantastic. You're one of the smart ones. That is such a good, you're so lucky. Well, I wish I could have helped you, but you know what? I bet you know other people I could help. I'd be happy to pay you $1,000 for any referrals. Whatever their answer is, I have a response for. And you'll learn those responses over time. What we're trying to do is get the bill, right? And to get a bill, we have to talk to people. We find somebody who says, oh, I've been interested in solar. Fantastic. I would love to help you. I've been doing this for 9 years. You know, I would love to see if I can help you save money. And if I can't, I promise you, I'll be honest with you and tell you it's a bad fit. What we need to do to start is I just need some basic information. I need your name, your phone number, email, address. And I need a copy of your bill. If you could do that, I can put together a proposal for you and I can set up either a Zoom meeting or in-person meeting, depending on the situation, and answer all your questions. I mean, after 9 years, I know most of the answers. And the ones I don't know, I have friends that will help me with. You know, so can we do that? Yes, I'd be happy to. Fantastic. Here's my information. Would you like to email it to me, text it to me? Or would you like me to come in person and pick it up? You know, let's get that bill. Let's figure this out. Then we have this fantastic platform, right? This Powur platform is so amazingly powerful. The solar software is incredibly easy to use. So we're going to submit that bill. We're going to put that bill into the system. We're going to fill out some basic information, you know, name, phone number, address, email, correct information. Oh my goodness. Fast story. First job I ever did in here, you know, the guy's name was Joe, right? So I put Joe in. And then we went to go do loan docs and stuff like that. Well, his name wasn't Joe. It wasn't even his first name. It was his middle name because he didn't want to be a junior, right? His real name was something else. So we had to go back and change order and fix things. Try to get accurate information. Don't put a fake email in just to put a bill in. Get a correct email. Ask the correct, hey, oh, Joe, is that short for Joseph? or whatever, right? Act information, submit it, get it in the system. And then tag it. If you're brand new, you're going to tag it. You're going to have somebody like, you know, one of us tier three mentors help you build a new quote, right? We're going to help you design that. We're going to walk you through. We're going to hold your hand, teach you why we make the choices we make so that we can accurately present this to the customer. Or in your case, once you get to a point where you can do it yourself, the tag it part becomes, you know, you request that proposal and then you're able to create it, manipulate it, and set it up for the presentation, either in person or via Zoom. Now, it's weird for me to say via Zoom, you know, doing this for 9 years. For 8 years, I closed every single deal, well over 1,000, in somebody's home at their kitchen table. And then this thing called COVID hit, and my life got turned upside down. And I found myself at home going, what am I going to do with all my time? And that's how I found Powur, by the way. I found it on a YouTube video. Some crazy guy named Jonathan, you know, JB, just some guy that does okay in this business. And I found Powur. And now I close the majority of my deals via Zoom. In other states, by the way, I got deals in Las Vegas, Texas, South Carolina. You know, people I've never met in my life, but because they were a friend or a family member of somebody I've done business with, they gave me the lead. I put together, I got a bill, I submitted it, I tagged it, created the proposal, and then set up a Zoom meeting. So that's the steps. Learn the steps. Follow the steps. Do not become, I used to have a term for this, but I am drawing a blank on the term. Don't change it. Don't try to make it, you know, don't add a fourth step. Don't take away a step. We already got this down to a science. Follow the steps. You know, do it like the people who are already successful are doing it, and you'll be successful. Tommy, you want to go to the next slide there? Where are we at there, my friend?
Are you seeing build your pipeline?
No, I'm still seeing get it, submit it, tag it.
Really? Is everyone else seeing get it?
Yeah, we are seeing. We are seeing build your pipeline. So that's where we are, Scotty.
This dark computer.
Okay. Okay. We got a brand new. You know, spend a couple $1,000s on a computer. You think it would work? let me do. I'm going to do something here real fast. I'm going to pull up everything on my side. So I can just kind of see where we're at. Give me just a second. I'm going to go down to, so I can see what you're looking at. Give me 1 second. Here we go. So build a pipeline. Basically what we were talking about before, you're going to want to introduce this program, what you do, to people you know, right? Friends, family, work associates, neighbors. You need to build a pipeline. In solar sales, we talked earlier about, we have, you know, 90 million homes that are available to do solar sales, more than 90 million. There's a ridiculous amount of people who have not done this yet. And they often have their own excuses or reasons why they haven't. You know, our job is to bring them in, let them know what we can and can't do. We got to build that pipeline. You, if you put three deals in and then you complain because you got zero results, then you're not thinking this through very well. This is a numbers game. You know, 9 years of doing this, I might average a little higher than you do, right? Maybe if I put four in, I might get two out of it. Maybe one, maybe zero, maybe four. My numbers might be different than somebody who's brand new. You need to build that. You don't want to put two in. You don't want to put four in. You want to put 400 in. We want to build that. And there's lots of ways of doing that. Like I said, friends, family, neighbors. When you do close a deal, talking to the neighbors. One of my favorite things to do is called cloverleafing. You know, I close a deal at, you know, 1122 Anywhere Street. And then I, on the day of install, I bring donuts to my installers. If it's local, it's my habit. My other habit is to go knock the doors around the house and apologize to them. I'm so sorry if we're making too much noise. Your neighbors going solar, I'm helping them save a bunch of money. I just want to apologize. We should be done in one day. Normally this just takes one day, sometimes two. You know, here's my name and number. If there's any problems, if anything falls in your yard, if there's anything you should know, I'd be happy to, you know, feel free to give me a call. I just want to apologize for the noise that we're making next door. Boy, it's amazing how many leads you get by just apologizing for something that's not going to actually be bad. You have to build that pipeline. You have to put the information in so we can actually communicate with people. I think we have a video on the next one there, Tommy, on the Build Your Pipeline.
Welcome back. In this module, we're going to take a look at how to build your pipeline. You now have effectively a solar sales and marketing organization of your own for only a moderate monthly cost. If you look at the way we approach things, in the next few minutes, you're going to learn how to have a conversation to show homeowners how to control the cost of their energy, add value to their home, turn a liability that they currently have that they don't control into an asset, and reduce their carbon footprint. Step number one is to create that list. Use the memory jogger that's provided to you during certification and begin to make that list. That list is the foundation of any successful campaign. It's a prospect list. A Powur prospect list is really a directory of those who could potentially benefit from going solar or from becoming a team member in your organization if you desire to have passive income. It's important to leave your comfort zone and list everyone who you may not even prejudge, if you will, into hearing about solar or hearing about the business, because you never know who is going to want to hear. So list everyone you know. Don't filter the initial list. Just create that list. Then you can go through the process of determining who you want to talk to about the business or who you want to talk to about solar. With regard to solar, learn a million-dollar sentence. This simple. Have you ever noticed that your energy prices have been steadily increasing over the past few years? Rarely will they say no. And if they do, it's because they're not paying attention. So let's help guide them through this. And you can then follow it up. Hey, did you see my post that I recently became an independent energy consultant with Powur Energy? No? Well, let me tell you a little bit about that. I'm now certified with Powur to help homeowners evaluate if solar's right for their home and could save them tens of thousands of dollars on their energy costs. So what are your thoughts about solar? At this point, you want to actively listen, take notes, and set you and your mentor up for success. Get with your mentor on that and talk through the best way to help accomplish that. If you get an objection, don't be sidetracked by that. It's very simple. Cushion, overcome, and go for the close. What's the close? It's this simple. That's a great question. Every home is different, so let's see what's true for your home. You may not even be eligible. There's no cost. There's no obligation. All it takes is a semi-electric bill, and we can get the process started. It's really that simple. So if I could show you a way to lock in your cost of energy, save you tens of thousands of dollars over the next 20 years, and help reduce your carbon footprint with absolutely nothing out of pocket, would you be open to a free consultation? Great. Just give me a copy of your bill and I'll get the process started. It's time to take action. Take a look at that list, create that list, and begin to set yourself up for success and do great things in this industry. Congratulations for completing building your pipeline.
Awesome. Awesome stuff. He's so sharp. I love that guy, man. That guy just blows me away. So much knowledge in one head. If you go to the next screen, you have that memory jogger. We're actually going to take a break here in a few minutes, and you guys are actually have a chance to write down some of this yourself. But all these tools are available to you guys, you know, in that that business plan. So, you know, right now, if you have a piece of paper or something like that, you're going to want to have that handy. But before we get there, if you go down to the next screen, it gives you some ideas of some of those member joggers, families and friends, you know, relatives, career people, you know, business people that you already are dealing with, associates. You know, this gives you some ideas of different people that you might want to consider for, you know, making sure they understand that you are in a position to help them. One of my favorite sayings, and I have a lot of them, is the answer is always no if you don't ask the question. So how can you help somebody save money if you don't let them know that you are in a position to do it? You know, I'm not trying to sell somebody a vacuum cleaner or a car or any other product that they may or may not need. I am actively trying to help people save money. I have the best job in the world. When I go out and about and I see my clients, They come up and give me a hug. They buy me a beer. They pat me on the back. You know, they are happy to see me. You know, when I, the last person I bought my car from, nothing against that. I don't remember if it was a guy or a girl. It was 3 years ago. I couldn't even tell you. I have no memory of that person. My clients remember me and they're happy to see me because my job is to help people save money. So you are in a position to help people. This is going to, you know, give you a reason why you should talk to people. And we're not just in California. If we go down to the next slide, right now we are in 27 states and growing. We are available to help people. And Puerto Rico, I believe, is going to be announced Monday. So it just doesn't have to be your local neighbors. You might have an Aunt Jenny in Nevada who is on fixed income and often complains about not having enough money. Guess what? We can probably help Aunt Jenny, or, you know, cousin Clyde in Texas, or your best friend you haven't seen in 5 years and that moved to South Carolina. You know, we can help people all across the United States. And with Zoom, it's actually pretty darn easy to do. So this is what we're going to do. We're actually going to help you start building your pipeline. We're going to take a couple minutes and we're going to let you write this stuff down. Some of you won't. I know you won't. Some people are just going to sit there and go have a break for 3 minutes. And that's your choice. For the ones who take the time to write some names down, you're way more likely to be successful. You're way more likely to start seeing some of those $7,000-$8,000. I have one coming in right now, $14,000 commission check coming in. So if you have a desire to have that text message come in that says, we've just deposited $14,000 into your account, which I love that, go ahead and use this time wisely and write some names down. Tommy, if you want to start that.
By the way, Scott, I see on that app all the time only 21 states, so I'm not sure where the other ones are coming from.
We are at 27 now, I believe.
We're in enough states.
Yeah, no question about that. I just, every time I talk to somebody, we have a different number. So.
You know what? Things go up and down. Dogs are barking. Wind was blowing. Stuff happens. Squirrels jump at you every now and then. Sometimes some states don't work out. Sometimes they do.
And sometimes I make mistakes. So it's very possible that my number.
We're not all perfect. We're trying, guys. We're trying here.
It's definitely a significant number. How about that?
And I know that number is actually actively growing. Yeah, I've been in talks with some people who are in the know, and I know of a couple states that are right on the cusp of being added to this list. So obviously our goal eventually is to be in all 50. You know, some states are more in a position to use solar than other states, obviously. But if you don't know anybody in Pennsylvania, write down your five neighbors. One thing I'm not used to is silence. It's not one of my strengths.
Yeah. Everyone's thinking hard.
Again, I know, I love it.
Think about.
I feel guilty that I'm not writing something down right now. I told everybody they should. I should be writing some more down. I know there's somebody I'm not talking to, and I should be.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you want another one of those $14,000 days, you need to.
You know what? That's a full gigantic system with a battery and a bunch of. And this customer is ecstatic because their bill is off the chart gigantic. They are ecstatic to get this thing done. And I'm saving them so much money over a 25-year period. It's like almost $200,000 savings for them.
That is insane to think about, that most of the nation makes that in about 6 months. That's friggin' insane.
for me personally, I love helping people save money. It's just such an amazing opportunity. I'm so blessed. And it's just so fun to see the light bulb go on after you do a presentation. Well, I hope you guys made an effort there and put some names on paper. Remember, action never produces negative. It always produces something positive. I promise you, positive action, positive results. So once you build this pipeline, obviously we need action. That means you actually have to let them know one way or another that you are a certified solar professional with Powur and that you are in a position to help them find out if this is a good fit for them or not. So you need to reach out to them. I always think that the voice is the best, phone call in person if possible. If not, text message, emails. Maybe it's a combination of everything, but you need to take some action. And what we're going to do, what's the first thing we're going to do? We're going to ask for an electric bill, right? We're not going to reinvent the wheel. We're going to ask for an electric bill. We're going to let them know that we're going to find out if we can help them. And we're going to get it, submit it, or tag it and submit it, right? Or I put the order wrong there, but we're going to do all three steps properly, I promise, so that we can find out if we can help them. I think we actually have one more short video on getting the bill. Is that not true, Tommy?
Yes, hold on a second. Let's see here. There we go.
Welcome back. In this module of certification, we're going to discuss getting the electric bill. But before we do, we want to take a step back and remind you of the million-dollar sentence that we coached you on in building your pipeline. And that is, have you noticed that your energy prices have been steadily increasing over the years? Once you get that conversation going, the next step that you're going to want to look for in that initial objective is to get the electric bill. There's three things that will determine whether you should invest more time into that home. It's covered in depth in the solar discovery call, but it's one, how much energy they use, two, how much they pay for a kilowatt hour of energy, and three, whether the roof and home is eligible for solar. Well, let's dive into why we need to know how much energy they use. Well, this determines the cost and the size of the system. Without knowing how much they use, it would be a guess. And this is the second or third largest decision a homeowner is going to make in their lifetime. So this is important to get it right. So if the homeowner says, well, what's this going to cost? Well, that's a great question. Every home's different. Let's see what's true for your home. Send me a recent electric bill and we can determine if this even makes sense for you. The second thing you want to look at is how much they're paying for a kilowatt hour of energy. And the easiest way to describe this is take the total amount they owe on the electric portion of their bill, not gas or sewage, but the electric portion of the bill, take those number of kilowatt hours and divide that in this particular case by 1,235. That's what will determine what their cost per kilowatt hour is. Generally speaking, we're looking for homeowners to be north of 10 cents per kilowatt hour. 11 to 12 is kind of what we call grid parity, where it begins to create an immediate level of savings. The more they pay, the better the value prop is going to be. So if you look at that, why do we need to know how much kilowatt hour cost? Because this determines the value proposition and the overall savings. So if a homeowner says, well, what's this going to save me? Well, that's a great question. Every home is different. Let's see what's true for your home. Just send me a recent electric bill and we'll take a look at it and see if this even makes sense for you. Folks, if you give them an understanding as to why you need what you're asking for, they're much more likely to provide you what you need because you're going to answer the question that they have. The third thing, and we're going to tie this into the electric bill here, and that is that we want to take a look at their roof and determine if the home is viable. Because again, every home's different. And in context here, there's 130 million single family residences in the United States of America, of which 90 million are eligible. So if you're speaking with the homeowner, if yours is one of the 40 million who are ineligible, I don't want to waste your time. Now, I can look at your roof from our satellite images, and I'll do that once I verify the service address on your electric bill. Go ahead and shoot me over a recent copy of that, and I'll go ahead and see if this makes sense for you. Again, those three things are how much they use, how much they pay, and whether the roof is eligible. You have that conversation, tie it all into why you need an electric bill and set yourself up for success. And now that you've done that, if you haven't already done this, which is take action, create that list and begin the process of setting up yourself for a long-term success within the Powur platform. Congratulations on completing getting an electric bill.
Ah, love it. And I love what he says, you know, you let them know, hey, did you notice electric bills are going up? Your costs are going up. You know, for me personally, what do you do? My favorite question, what do you do? And so they'll start a conversation. And what's nice is that there's not one way to talk to people. There's lots of ways, but there's all this information, all this knowledge is at our fingertips. Inside the platform, we have a knowledge base, and there are so many videos, so many helpful documents in there to help you become better at this. We have trainings every week, Monday morning with JC, Tuesday morning with JB. There's things going on Wednesdays and Thursdays. There's every Monday at 5 o'clock, maybe the most important meeting of the whole week, helping you build your team. If you don't know how to do something, if you're not sure why or how, or you're not quite get your head quite around it, ask. I promise you that information is available to us. So I hope this was somewhat helpful. I hope you guys really are ready to start building your business. This is a business. This is your business. And I promise you it will be incredibly successful if you just keep start taking positive actions and helping or asking the tier three mentors to help you hold your hand and get you there. Learn why you earn. Tommy, I'm going to turn it back over to you, my friend.
Thank you so much, Scott. Really appreciate that. That was fire. Always. I love hearing it. Just comes off so clear and concise. So guys, we are one training away from our special guest appearance, and this one is going to be perfect to get you off the ground. Now, I'm going to bring back up Mr. Bill Conley, 9 years solar energy experience. Just a fantastic person. And Bill, are you going to need me to share my screen, or would you like to share yours for the 10 pennies?
We'll just let you keep going. You're doing such a good job, Tommy. And hey, I just want to say what a tremendous training we've had today. I hope that some, especially for you new people, that this has been a valuable session for picking up the nuts and bolts of what we do and how we do it. And I'm going to break it down into daily actions to keep it simple and to let you know that anybody can do this business. And it is very simple. And we do it with a little analogy called 10 pennies. You see, the only way that people can fail in Powur in this business is by not talking to people about solar. Scott was phenomenal in terms of describing how he's solar all the time. And you don't have to be, but it's so easy to do it. And what we want to do is not, you know, put ourselves in somebody's face. Hey, can I sell you solar? You know, we don't want to be the Costco person, you know, grabbing somebody with that hook to pull them in. We just want to have conversations with people as we go about our day, every day. The best way to have conversations is by being interested in other people and starting a conversation. Again, like Scott had said, you know, what do you do? Just a very casual conversation. And the way to track your conversations and get to the point of talking about solar, because you're going to work your conversation around to what you're doing, and that's helping people save money with solar. We call it the 10 penny plan. The 10 penny plan, and I have in my hand here 10 pennies here. I'm not going to count them for you, but there's 10. I had to go looking for them. because I didn't have them handy. But if with 10 pennies, you can put them either as you go out through the day in your left pocket, or if you're at your desk on the left side of your desk. And every time you start a conversation with someone, you take a penny and you're going to move it from the left pocket or the left side of your desk to the right side as you talk to them about solar. And you're going to say something that's very casual and natural in terms of asking them about how they're doing, their family. They used to talk about form, right? Family, occupation, recreation, I don't know, money, or what, however that goes. But you're going to talk to them about a topic that eventually gets to the point where you ask them about if they've noticed their electric bill rising, or if in fact they're interested in saving money on a bill that they have every month that's never going to go away. And you use those 10 pennies one at a time to track your conversations. If you'll do that consistently on a daily basis, and here are some examples of the kinds of questions to start conversations, you know, online, if you're a social media, hey, you know, I see that you live in Texas, and these may be friends or people that you just meet, but you want to get to the point of talking about the idea of, have you looked at solar? Are you interested in saving money on a bill, again, that never goes away? We have a way for no money out of pocket to save you as much as 50% every single month on a bill, to increase the value of your home, to take advantage of some awesome federal tax credits that are available. You are just going to use those 10 pennies as a reminder, as a way to track, and maybe you can build it up to more. But if you will do that every single day, the 10 penny rule applies. I'm going to talk to 10 people. I'm going to start 10 conversations. I guarantee you that if you're brand new, that you'll get enough presentations done, and you'll collect enough bills and get enough presentations that you will have at least 3 sales if you will do this consistently every day for 30 days. And that's going to come because you're going to leverage the power of our platform and the tier 3 sellers to help you close. Remember, all we do is get it, submit it, tag it. And those 10 pennies are just a great tool and a great way to have you go from zero to money in your pocket. Those 10 pennies will turn into $10,000. Okay, how'd you like that? Now we're going to take getting an electric bill. We're going to take a minute. I don't know that we've already taken some time here, but if you want to reach out in the next minute on a social media or a text and ask somebody, start a conversation about the fact that you've just got involved with solar, or you're working on your solar business right now, you'd like to see if you can talk to them about getting a copy of their bill. You can do that in the next minute.
Yeah, guys, an easy way to go about this is just think of friends, family members. Everyone has that one person in their head that they know that they wanted to reach out to or need a reason to. Just say, hey, it's been a while. How's it going? How are you doing? And just see what's up with them. They'll text you back. Didn't start off awkward. And then the next, you just take it from there. Just ask them what they're doing, how they're living. And when they respond, tell you about their work, whatever, ask you what you're doing. Guess what? Drop a solar bomb. Okay, guys, so I just texted a project that failed credit a while back because I realized it's around that 3-month mark right now. So that's when their credit can start getting better and I can start getting back at that lead. So don't ever give up on following up, because it is where the gold is. Okay. Bill, this is, sorry guys, random Espanol. So, all right, here we go. Guys, thank you so much, Bill. Appreciate you taking care of that. Agenda has been concluded for the day, and we get to have our special guest today. This is I consider him a pretty good friend now. We have a funny story together, Mr. Mike Winter. He was at Sunrun and applying for being on the same BNI chapter that I was trying to get into at the time. So me and him were going head to head, and I found a way to just weasel him out of there. And I got my way into my chapter, and thankfully he found another one. He is on a team, My Solar Solutions with Kiara, that is absolutely crushing it. His social media game is on point. If you don't follow him, you should go follow him. It is Solar Mike, if I'm not mistaken. And yeah, Mike, if you're on, man, let's go ahead and let you take it away. I wish I knew enough about team building when I met you originally. And he's the one that got away. Mike, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me all right?
Yes, you're loud and clear, Mike.
Yeah, it was funny. I started with Sunrun, and that's when I was knocking doors in San Diego, and I was in that. I thought I had it, the BNI group. I had it. I mean, I had applied, and then you showed up. I was like, who is this guy? And then I was like, what is this solar company? Like, they spelled Powur wrong. There's no way this guy's getting it. I didn't know anything. I thought Sunrun was still like the premier thing to be part of. And yeah, Tommy, you should have grabbed me.
Yeah, sorry, man. I had a little experience with Sunrun. I knew.
Yeah, you said it. Anyway, I did want to fight Tommy for a while. And then anyway, I found a new chapter and it's all good. But one of it brings up a funny point, which is, like, when I was with a door knocking company, they almost discouraged that, you know, get a BNI group or go to networking events. They kind of have their like, hey, let's just knock doors. And Powur is such a different thing. And so I want to talk about like why social media matters to that and what has happened to my like entire career because of all that. So my story kind of goes, let me share my screen. Let's see here. You guys see my browser? It's my account. Yeah. Let's see this switched here. One second. Sorry.
Whoa. Deep dark.
I'm recording. So I'm going to tell you why I'm pausing right now, because I'm recording this, of course, because I'm going to make a post out of what I'm doing right now. And that's one of the things that I want to talk about is you to do this successfully. As long as you're busy, you need to start making like a movie out of it where you're the star. And I'm going to talk about the reasons why that's so effective, especially with Powur and the way we use networking. So, this is my page. I started knocking doors a few years ago, and then I started to just say like, hey, I'm going to post online. And one of the reasons I started doing this, I wasn't some social media person. I could just see that there was a lack of trust in this industry around because of all the door knocking. So and then I saw on social media that there wasn't that like established, like the realtor space right now. If you look at that, super competitive on social media, like, to go on there and be like someone that creates great content, really competitive. In the solar space, not so much. Like, some old dad like me is like doing stuff and it works. And I didn't necessarily, I mean, I could see early on that like there wasn't a lot of good content. And that space is still wide open for and there's a lot of people doing a lot of great things right now, but there's definitely not like the realtor space yet where it's sort of inundated. But there's a reason why like it works so well with Powur. So when I was in the door knocking space, I started doing social media and I was kind of looked at like, hey, why are you wasting your time with that? And like I said, I wanted to establish trust with my customers. I wanted them to see that like, hey, I know what I'm talking about. This was my like initial frame of mind when I started it. I want to be an expert. I want them to be able to see that I've helped customers and those people are happy. And then I want them to see that I'm a normal person that, and kind of a dork too. So I just want them to see, like, I want to show that who I am, you know, this becomes like a reflection of who you are. And that's what I wanted to show, all in the like hope that maybe I'd get an extra deal a quarter out of it. I didn't realize that I would join a company like Powur and I'd be able to use social media to network so well. I mean, it's kind of perfect. So the idea here is establishing your personal brand, which you can do on Instagram, you get LinkedIn, there's all these different ways. But once you have your personal brand established, then you can focus on the most effective way to find homeowners that are ready for solar. And that's not door knocking. It's not buying leads. It's networking. So networking is what I changed, and now it's like I want to see. It's funny. So Marissa, which I haven't met you, Marissa, but I've sent your video to a lot of people because your video that they showed in the latest realtor Powur Day thing that we had is just, that's what we all, those we all want to find the realtor that's been doing it for 20 years that sees it and then does what Marissa's done when we're trying to build teams. And so once you have your brand, and you don't need to be as crazy as me, let's say you have 9 to 10 posts, enough to just create your first like grid, you can then start reaching out and saying like, hey, person in a new state we just opened up, like, I don't know. So the next state we open up, take your Instagram account and message 20 people a day that are realtors over there and say, hey, do you know what this is about? Send them Marissa's video. And they'll be like, wait, what can I do? And that's a whole huge thing, but you can't do that without something to say like, hey, if you want to hear about this, talk to someone like me. And so, you know, it's intimidating when you think, should I do Instagram? Do I really have to like do something this stupid? Like, I can't look this dumb.
I wish you had the sound on for that so people could hear you clicking. I click Instagram all the time. It's fantastic, full of good stuff.
So you really just have to say to the world, and a lot of the speakers today have mentioned it. Scott said it too, like the idea is everyone in your network, in your spheres, all of them know that this is what you do and that you're obsessed with it. So doing an Instagram page for your solar, you can kind of show your obsession for it. And that's one of the things I'm trying to portray is like, I don't dress up, like I dress up my solar panel in a Halloween costume. That's how like stupid I am. And I do arts and crafts. So it's like, wow, that guy's obsessed with solar. And that's a way you can show that. That's who people want to partner with when they want to get into the space. But having a brand allows you to send it out to people. And then in social media, it's easy to connect. Like all the LinkedIn, I know David Steele has his LinkedIn strategies, which I'm no expert at, and I still need to get into that. But I have strategies over here on Instagram that I use because I have all this. Well, there's tons of different ways to do this. The idea is have something that says you're a pro and then get it out to as many people as you can. And it really expands. My team, I started in March with Powur, and I spend most of my time with my team and new people that are just coming in. And it's mostly from Instagram. It's mostly from me reaching out to groups or people in solar or people that are in home services industry. I've used my Instagram page to recruit turf salesmen and realtors and window washers. And you can do anything across any part of the country as long as you have a brand. So build a brand. That's what I'm saying.
Love it.
So how do you do it? I wanted to give a few tips. Am I okay on time? If I just go into like,
yeah, okay. I think everyone's enjoying this. Mike, I really want to know. I have some questions for you at the end. So just let me know whenever you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Cool. Was anybody at Powur World?
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. So I was the dork on the stage. Where is it? So this was kind of, did I pass it? There's Powur Day. Here it is. Yeah. There's the end when we're busting. What a party. Go to this event in San Diego next year. This was so fun. I couldn't even believe it. So we had a panel at Powur World, and it was a social media panel, and we met before the panel, and we're all talking about what to talk about. And I said like, well, hey, let's create a post. And I think the message I'm trying to share with that is when you decide like, hey, I'm going to do social media, the most important thing is you have to plan out what you're going to post. So I use Trello as one of boards for everything. So you can see this is my Trello board for what I'm going to do on Instagram. You might just use like a notepad. It doesn't matter. But I'll just, I have all my ideas running through. And then on Sundays or sometime on the weekend, I will plan out what my posts are for that week. And I would say the biggest challenge in social media is not creating the videos. It's not like editing the videos. It's thinking about what you're going to do. It's like the mental process for coming up with ideas. And you'll get better and better at that. But if you sit down on a Sunday and say like, hey, let's look at my week. Like, what do I have an install this week? Am I going to a networking event? Do I have something on Zoom that might be cool to record? So I'm going to stop that recording I just made. So now I have a clip. I had a quote in when I first started talking. I already knew I was going to post me saying that thing. It's recorded. My post for Monday is now ready. So like you get used to kind of going through your solar career and being like, oh, that's something that's noteworthy. When you guys were talking about the Anaheim stuff and the annoying nature of that buyback program and that kind of stuff, that to me, I was instantly thinking like, oh, that's a post. Like I can make like an educational post out of that. I wouldn't because I'm in San Diego, but if I was in that area, I'd do a 25-second video saying like, hey, this utility and solar, they're married like this. This is why this is important. Have a nice day. Like that, that's super valuable stuff. Easy to do. You can do it while in your car or whatever. But you get a lot of respect for being able to turn on a camera and talk. You don't have to do that to create a brand, but that's something that will really matter. So you can see here, I don't know where these are going to go next week. These are just like some ideas that I've had in here. You guys seen that Zac Efron video where he's talking to a bear? Like it was so funny to me. I'm going to do that with my solar panel. It's going to be weird and stupid, but it's in my list. So I'm going to do it. So that what I'm saying is like make a plan, but plan it around your life. So if you're going to Power World, and we made a stupid post on that stage because the lesson I'm trying to teach there is whatever you're doing is the content. And as long as you stay busy in solar, then it's clear you're busy, you're successful, but you might go fishing too. And people want to see that. And you might go to some video game place that me and my boys are obsessed with video games. So I post on that, but kind of sprinkle in the solar. So it's however you want to do it, but it should be a reflection of you. Make it genuine, make it personal, show people your life and then show them how obsessed you are with solar, and it will work. And you don't need, the goal isn't to like have the most followers. I've never made any effort to like, because I use this as a tool to network and find people to work with. I'm not trying to be an Instagram star. I'm trying to use it to connect to people that I need to push my business forward. How do I do it? I would say like people have like, one of the things that gets intimidating for people are, like the video editing and stuff. That's a big question. There's so much resource out there to be able to say like, hey, how did I do this video in video? You know, so me talking, the end phase event, the Power World event, this isn't hard stuff. You just have to, when you get the idea to do it, that's when you go learn how to do that. So don't worry about knowing all that. Let it come as you think of an idea like, oh, I see Mike did like a post where he's wobbling. Like, what in the world is that? And that's just an easy Snapchat filter or whatever I did it on. I think it was an Instagram filter, but whatever. I didn't know how to do that before. I just saw someone doing it. It looked stupid. I thought I can hold up my panel and be stupid and let it wobble. And it was easy. But you don't need to learn everything technically. Just take it as it comes, as you get the ideas. And then, oh yeah. So go to vid editing tools for starting. I love the app InShot. I use InShot for like a lot of stuff because I find it really easy. I'm just looking at other questions here. Okay. Does anybody have, Tommy, did you have a specific question you wanted to ask?
Man, you just been dropping knowledge bombs on me. I was going to ask you about how you plan your social media posts, because planning is really important for that. And so you answered that. So I appreciate that.
Just a little more on that. So I don't, I post every day at the same time of day. So it's like, I know on the weekend, on Sunday, like tomorrow, I'll know what the whole week is, so that when I go to events or go to an install or go do something, I know I need to record something that day. And then I have it ready, and then I post it in the morning. And then I pretty much ignore everything after that. So you don't want to be on social media all the time, because you want to stay busy and working. I mean, you can be, but I really treat it as like a very scheduled, disciplined thing, because I don't want to spend a ton of energy on it. I want to decide, I want to create the content, post it at the same time every day, and then get on with my stuff.
Yeah, that's a great way to look at it, and a great way to keep your time, your time. You got to control it so that your life doesn't control you, your work doesn't control your family time and all that good stuff.
Any other questions? Let's see. I would say, don't be scared. You know how many times I turned on a camera and started talking? Oh, and when I started, my content was a lot about door knocking. Like you will develop over time, and you'll just get better and better the more you do it.
Mike, I have
the question is, yeah, go ahead.
Can you show us the video of like how you made your BNI presentation, your first one, your feature, where you like got really professional out of nowhere? Do you know what I'm talking about? Where you did your feature presentation and you had immediately like just played with the background or the I don't want to even spoil it for everyone. I don't know how to say it, but you turned yourself professional digitally.
Oh, I put the suit on?
Yeah, dude. I was trying not to blow it.
Oh, I remember that one.
It's little
things. That's a great one, by the way. On PC, it's called Snap. It's called Snap Capture or something. I don't have it installed right now because I got a new machine, but you can put filters during a Zoom call, and you do that with customers, like throw on a suit. It's funny. They love stuff like that.
Those are serious.
I don't know where that is.
Bombs right there. Making stuff funny is always a way to break ice and keep things conversational instead of, sometimes when you hit that wall, drop a joke, do little things like Mike. He always refers to everything he does as stupid, but it's absolutely stupid to think that.
Well, dude, I mean, come on. That's a solar panel.
Like,
that is a, I think need to make Mike that an electric one.
I think Mike is stupidly taking this to the bank every single week. I want to be as stupid as Mike, please. I want to be as stupid as Mike.
Well, so there's a question here. Do I recruit ambassadors and sellers? And so I want to make a point to like what happens with when you have an audience in the solar space, like I do. I started this thinking I was going to get leads from it, which I still do. Like people might see it and be like, oh, can you help me with solar? But this is what's really happened is when I joined Powur, it's all the people in the solar space, they follow it. And then they say like, hey, what's this Powur thing? But I don't get on here and say like, hey, join Powur every day. But I will obviously come on here and be like, hey, you know, Powur's cool. And here's why. So the question on here is, do I recruit sellers? Yes. I mean, I actually haven't actively started recruiting because it's kind of a constant flow of people that want to join Powur. And that's the other thing too. So I was at Sunrun, this big company. You guys that are maybe weren't over there, some people probably were over there. But there's this massive wave coming to this company. And I think Scott said it too, like I could go anywhere. All of us that know what we're doing, we can go sell anywhere. If there was something better, we would go do it. If I had better tools and can make more money, why wouldn't I switch tomorrow? I would. In fact, when I'm going up against some other company, I'm like, show me the proposal. Cause if, if it's better than what I can give you, customer, I will go sell for them. That's how I'm set up. And I've said that to homeowners, like, if you have something that can beat me, I really want to see it, because I'd love to offer that to you as well. By the way, the only thing that could beat us was this company, and this is what I posted today. So this is great news, guys.
I love it. Does anyone want to hop off of mute real fast before we're almost done here? And like, thank you, Mike, so much. Does anyone want to say something that they learned today, or something that stuck out to them? Was social media is one of those things that you got to have a creative mind, and it doesn't have to be complicated. Mike just thinks of these things, and he's just a genius when it comes to social media, and he doesn't even know it or give himself credit. But does anyone want to talk about something they learned?
There's a couple questions on here.
Okay.
Instagram versus Facebook. I was early on I just don't like Facebook personally. I literally haven't logged into my Facebook account in a long time. I do post on TikTok. But I haven't really tried on TikTok. So I sort of, I really focus on Instagram reels. You can see every one of my posts every day is a reel, even if it's just a picture, like this, these are pictures, but I put on cool music and I made it a reel and scrolled through, because reels just get more views. So I will take some of these and put them on TikTok, like something dumb like this. Not like me and my kid and stuff like that, but and then I'm going to start putting YouTube shorts as I'm doing next.
So Mike, I got a quick question for you.
Yeah.
I'm Craig Bloom. I'm out in Baltimore, Maryland. How are you, brother? I thought I saw you. I remember seeing you on stage, man. That was pretty neat when you're doing all the knuckle crack and everything. I thought I saw you at Grant Cardone. I wasn't sure. I was getting confused. But let me ask you this. I do the same thing as well. I try to post every day. And so my question is, do you ever repost stuff? I mean, you know, so because once in a while, you know, I think, man, that was really neat content. And I put it out there, but then I try to find something else and find something else and find something else and recreate. And I get that. But do you ever go back and go, you know what? That would really work. Let me
this send it back out there again. Totally. This is a repost right here. I posted this 2 weeks ago, and I had posted it like 9 months ago.
Gotcha.
So once in a while, when I'm sort of out of ideas, this was a repost. This was a repost. So yeah, I would say like once they get like a year old, or I mean, I don't know. I don't think it matters. If it's good content, then it doesn't matter. But yeah, I'm comfortable doing it when I just don't have an idea, and I'll go through my old ones and be like, hey, what do I like? And I have so limited from my early days, cause I've got a Sunrun shirt on every time, but
gotcha. So, thank you.
Yeah.
Hey, Mike,
go ahead.
My name is Frankie J. There's two things. First of all, you said that you use Marissa's for real estate agents. Could you tell me where you found that and how often you use that?
So this right here, this video, they have posted this in Knowledge Base, this slide deck.
Yeah, that's a great post.
Yeah. So go to Knowledge Base and find the real estate. What was that called? Was it Power Day? Was something else?
Career Week.
Yeah, search Career Week. This is one of the best videos they've made, because Marissa's awesome. And then it's just right on point. I showed this to a group of realtors. It was like, it was awesome.
Yeah.
Simply. Yeah. It's just perfect. And you could just like, imagine messaging this to some realtors and be like, hey, have you ever thought about offering solar, send this video. And then what happens is they say, yeah, I want to listen. Well, then you get the slide deck that Tommy used. The main Power Hour slide deck, and get used to presenting that, because if you reach out, you'll find that you're spending half your day not selling solar, but teaching people how to join Power, which turns this into a whole different game, which is more fun.
Okay. Thank you.
I love it. All right, guys. I'd say that Mike absolutely crushed that. I appreciate you hopping on and being our special guest. I secretly look at his profile for inspiration all the time. And I don't agree that he doesn't post on Facebook, because he will get a lot of business from Facebook. I'm telling you,
I know.
Maybe that's next level that he's going to achieve. So guys, thank you so much for joining us today. I want to share a couple little things. If you guys liked what you saw today, well, we're going to have some more of that coming on pretty soon. So if you can see my screen, I'm going to host again. Let's go. So December 10th, that's our next Powur Day in San Diego. Hopefully I have a team that's going to be joining me. Wanted to thank everyone that was on today for just taking the time out of your day and getting some knowledge dropped on you by some of the industry's best people and top solar reps. I mean, think about it. Powur has people with 9 years experience rolling through to this opportunity. There's a reason. There's not anything better. It's the same thing everywhere you go, a dealer model, or dealers for dealers, or just stuff that doesn't give you five streams of income. So guys, thank you so much for being on today. Does anyone have any last questions before we cut out?
I don't have any last questions, but I know that you're probably going to remind everybody about Monday night.
Absolutely. So guys, we're going to connect with our tier threes if we have them, or anyone that brought you here today. Also, stay focused on getting it, submitting it, tag it. Guys, the results you achieve will be in direct proportion to the effort that you apply. Whatever you want in your life, same for everyone. Money, time, happiness, fulfillment, it's definitely available for you here on Powur's platform, and it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. So lastly, before we exit out, don't leave us yet. We got to have some last words for our fearless
greetings, leader, fellow solar superstars. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. And at first, I just want to congratulate and thank everybody for showing up to our first virtual Powur Day. You know, we're always trying to do something different here at this company and how we engage our country and the people all over the world in the conversation of solar and in accelerating the adoption of sustainable energy worldwide. So thanks for participating in our crazy experiments. And I hope you've been having a wonderful day, learning so much and getting a chance to connect with the amazing leaders across this company. Now, what I want to share with you as CEO of Powur and as someone whose primary job is to really look at the marketplace and... is aligned with that future, and we've got enough money in the bank to execute on all our goals, right? So as that person, here's what I want to share with everybody listening to this video right now. You know, we're at a pivotal turning point in the solar industry. When Powur first began 8 years ago, I can promise you there was no one who was beating down my door to learn about solar, get a quote, you know, find out how much money they could save, you know, all of the stuff that you hear about solar energy. Nobody. The market was so different. You know, it was still so much younger, so much in a push and demand. You know, we have to go create demand. We have to go push. We have to go educate. If I didn't go out there and find customers, nobody was coming to me. And you fast forward to today, and it's really changing. I can't even tell you, just this week alone, this week, just 1 week, I've had five people in my network, contact, friends, relatives, colleagues, you name it, hit me up and ask me about solar. You know, one of my friends from high school hit me up, hey man, I've been seeing these ads all over the place and I'm curious, like, is this real? I had multiple investors in Powur all hit me up, hey, you know, what's going on? Should we get this soon? Blah, 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 blah. I had two other people hit me up, just referrals from people that I know. Hey, I know you went and got solar. I had a neighbor walking by my house, ask me, you know, just walking by, one of my neighbors just, oh, hey, I heard you were in solar. This neighbor over here said, and It's just insane right now. If you take the time to position yourself as a leader, as a man or woman of value, as somebody who has value to offer your community with this product, I promise you, we're entering a boom time for this industry that you can't buy that kind of timing. And, you know, I could probably look back in history and see, you know, how many products really changed society. How many products really went through a mass adoption curve and society was different afterwards. Computers, cell phones, automobiles. You know, these are some of the big ones that come to mind, right? And you look at the businesses that were positioned, right? Think the largest companies in the world today, Apple, Microsoft, right? They were positioned in front of that computer boom, that phone boom, that mobile phone, smartphone boom. You know, and you look at where we are with solar right now, and I'm telling you, this product is going to change society. You know, what we can do with this product, we can generate electricity from your freaking rooftop, from the sun hitting your roof. What an insane asset resource that we didn't even know was available. We have money being printed off our rooftop every single day, as long as we install that solar panel system up there and can harvest that sunlight. And we decentralize energy production. We no longer need giant utilities. We don't need these centralized entities anymore. We can take our power back. We can produce energy from the sun. We can become energy independent, not reliant on all these other countries for our energy or whatever it may be. We can empower our economies because this is the cheapest form of energy in America today, for God's sakes. And oh, by the way, it's massively labor intensive. These aren't a bunch of big machines like the fossil fuel industry, which, by the way, that's what it primarily is giant machines. It's not a labor-intensive industry. It's a machine-intensive industry. This is not that. This industry is highly labor-intensive. So as we scale solar in America, you're going to see millions of jobs get created. Millions! The solar industry is already 300,000 people large, the solar workforce, and we're only 3% of America's energy production. Come on! I mean, there's so much more we can do. 3% in terms of residential adoption. I mean, to clarify, there's a lot more production from utility and commercial scale. But in any case, I hope the point is coming through that this product is an absolute game changer. And you don't have an opportunity like you have right now in this company, in Powur, every day. You just don't. We're positioned in front of that boom. And with the passage of the recent climate legislation, and all of the insane incentives that are going to be behind clean energy for the next 12 years straight, all of our phone numbers, right? If you're a real professional, if you serve your customers right, if you educate them, if you design great systems for them, if you put their needs first, if you're values focused, how can I contribute the most value to my clients? If you do that, you're going to have your phone blowing up for the next decade with referrals out the wazoo, and people who are looking to you as the man or woman who they associate with solar when they come to make this big decision. And the writing is on the wall. We're already seeing it. Our platform is producing record incomes for record amounts of people and record growth month after month, quarter after quarter, and it's truly just the beginning. So the question is, honestly, what are you waiting for? I mean, what could be better than a career in a business filled with passion and purpose, solving one of the world's biggest challenges, making the world sustainable for all future generations, changing how we produce energy, decentralizing our grid, bringing independence back to people's homes in America? What the heck could be better? And oh, by the way, making an amazing living, an amazing income while you're doing it. So I truly hope you see the vision of what this product and this platform can do for your life. And make the decision now, make this decision today, whether or not you're gonna be a part of this moment in history, this historical time period that we're living in right now, where we, you and me and the people right around you right now, we've got the ability to build a new energy grid, a new way to power the world. And that way of powering the world is gonna transform what's possible on this planet. We're gonna enter an era of total abundance of energy. There's no limit to the energy from the sun, and we can unlock that, and we can unlock that energy at the cheapest cost that energy has ever existed. And what's that gonna do for society? And that's what you have a chance to do right now. That's the role you're playing. So join us on this
amazing mission to accelerate the adoption of sustainable energy and bring the benefits of solar power to all. And while you're doing it, create an amazing business, an amazing career for yourself. Thank you so much to all of our leaders who played your role in organizing today's event and the constant mentorship and training and inspiration that you are to the thousands and thousands of people across the nation who are developing a career with Powur. I appreciate every one of you so much. And to all of our new people who are listening to this message for the first time, I truly hope we get a chance to work together. I don't think you will find a better industry and a better platform than Powur, maybe in your lifetime. So take a real close look. And if this message resonates with you, join us. Get started. Let's go change the world. Let's go change your life. Let's go do something absolutely epic together. I'll see you all at the next one. Greetings, fellow solar.
Greetings again. Sorry. Guys, thank you so much. It's really been a pleasure. We want to remind everyone that Monday night, Powur Hour. So get anyone, any new eyes on Zoom on Monday. It is a business opportunity presentation, probably much better than the one that I put on, but it's going to be from our top elite guys. So Monday night, that's what we're looking forward to. Scott, Marisa, Bill, anything that you guys want to add?
And I just want to say congratulations to you, Tommy, and running a great show. It was phenomenal. Marisa and Scott, you were excellent. Just so happy to be a part of this. And for those of you that showed up today, I hope it was worth your time and that you take this and go forth and conquer.
Yeah, let's go, guys. Let's get some utility bills. Let's get them submitted, tag it, and let's crush it.
Thank you, everybody. Have a great day.
Great job, everybody. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Have a great weekend.
Powerful weekend, guys.
Adios.
Adios.